swapping him for Penny Hardaway. And then 11 years later, Orlando, they were at it again with the number one pick. You're sensing a little bit of a theme here. They have some experience in this department. They selected a center. You can see it there, Dwight Howard, three-time defensive player of the year. He's laid Orlando on another finals run in 2009. And Orlando, again, with the chance to pick number one overall. Before we dissect who could be that number one pick, I do want to check in with our senior NBA insider, Adrian Wojnarowski, to find out what exactly you are hearing, Woj, on who the Magic may select.
Malika, NBA teams are now preparing for the top of this lottery to see the draft board blown up. I'm told that the Orlando Magic are expected to select Duke's Paolo Banchero with the number one overall pick. Orlando's president of basketball operations, Jeff Weltman, ran one of the great stealth pre-draft operations, and I'm told that Banchero now is the front runner and the likely choice to be Orlando's pick at number one.
Wow. All right. Paolo Banchero out of Duke, likely to be the number one pick. But Woj, one of the interesting things about this draft is just how much talent there is at the top. It's begging this question of the Orlando Magic. Hey, Magic, who you got? Who will you be taking? Might it be Gonzaga's Chet Holmgren that they could take? He's a rim protector. He has perimeter skills. And here's the thing. Don't let his frame, his body type fool you. That is a tough dude. Or could it be Auburn's Jabari Smith Jr.? He's an elite jump shooter, a versatile defender. He has a high motor. And then there's Paolo Banchero, who Woj mentioned. He's a playmaker. He's physical. He's an elite scorer. So now we ask the question, who you got, Magic? And who you got, Jay?
Well, we had talked earlier about Jabari Smith being the number one pick, the presumptive number one pick, or Chet Holmgren of Gonzaga. It seemed like teams had moved away, and we had it slotted with Smith, Holmgren, and then Banchero going right to Houston. But apropos, a Woj bomb before the draft even starts, and it's Banchero. So if they take Banchero, now all of a sudden Oklahoma City, do they have a choice to make between, they didn't probably didn't expect that it was going to be Smith or Holmgren, number two. So that is a big shakeup at the top from what we thought it was going to be. But how exciting for all these guys, but how exciting for Paolo Banchero to join that long list of great players that have called themselves number one draft picks. And if he is taken number one, we talked about it all year, that there were three guys worthy of it, and those three guys are all worthy of it.
Well, guess what, Jay? We get to find out now. The pick is in, so let's go to Commissioner Adam Silver to find out who the Orlando Magic select.
With the first pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Orlando Magic select Paolo Banchero from Duke University.
Mike Miller.
Wow. Paolo Banchero from Duke goes number one overall to the Orlando Magic. You can see him hugging his family there. What a special moment. He comes from a family of hoopers. His mom, Rhonda Smith, she played at Washington, go Huskies, was drafted to the W in 2000. And he is a strong, offensively versatile player. He actually played quarterback, and he ran track and field in high school. He was an early bloomer. He continued to grow, and ultimately, he became the first Duke player with 20-plus points and 10-plus rebounds in a Final Four game since 1989. You can see him there shaking hands with Commissioner Adam Silver. What exactly are the Orlando Magic getting, Jay?
Well, they are getting maybe the best combination of size at 6'10", 255 pounds, advanced skills, and explosive power in this draft. And Orlando clearly thinks that Paolo Banchero is the best player in this draft. He was the best player on a team that had five NBA players in the starting lineup. And Paolo Banchero led Duke to a win over Gonzaga early in the season, where he outplayed Chet Holmgren. Here you see the physicality of Banchero. He can overpower defenders going to the basket. He can take it one way, spin back with power to the other. He can shoot it from the perimeter. He can isolate in the mid post on the elbow. I think he can get better as a defender, but when you look at his defense, his pick and roll defense is in the 97th percentile on pick and roll handling.
Absolutely, and when you look at his player comp, he's a combination of Michael Beasley with his elite skill set for us being able to score the ball, get buckets, create, and score it with difficulty. On the other end, I look at Ben Simmons, his ability to make plays for others, his ability to attack in transition and make plays and get to the basket downhill and take up the space. He has that physicality that you were talking about, Jay, and that's what he is. LSU Ben Simmons at that.
And a good
well, and now he is standing by with our Monica McNutt.
Paolo, Mom Rhonda, congratulations. Yesterday you told me you've been watching the NBA draft closely since 2010. Now that you're here and the number one pick, how does it compare to what you dreamed?
I don't even know what to say. I can't believe what just happened, honestly. I never would have thought that this would happen. You know, I wanted to be in the NBA, but I didn't know I would be here, man. I really honestly didn't. So this is unbelievable, and I can't speak right now. I'm sorry.
Well, we'll give you a break from speaking because we have a little surprise from someone special to you.
Paolo, congratulations. I'm so happy for you and your family and the commitment you've made. You are, I think, the most versatile player in the draft. You can play anywhere on the court, and you're a winner. You're going to help tremendously and have a terrific NBA career.
You join the legacy of Duke players drafted into the league and got to play for a legend. What did your experience as a Blue Devil teach you?
Taught me a lot, you know. Coach K, he really taught me, you know, how to really be a man, you know. Just being away from home, being so far from home, like he was there for me, you know, whether it was criticizing me, telling me when I was messing up, or complimenting me, letting me know when I was doing well. You know, he was always there, and he's the greatest coach I ever had.
Before there was Coach K, there was your mom, Rhonda, who has joined us this evening. But we've got to go back upstairs. Congratulations, Paolo. Congratulations, Mom Rhonda. We know you are his inspiration.
Thank you.
Monica, thank
you. Monica, thank you so much. Just take another look at this moment between Paolo and his mom, Rhonda. She has coached him. She has been his mentor. What a moment for him and his family. But look, I mean, Duke, they have a little bit of experience going number one overall. He joins a very elite list of number one picks, Elton Brand, Kyrie Irving, and Zion Williamson as Duke players who have gone number one overall. By the way, the 13th straight year that a freshman was selected first. The last non-freshman was Blake Griffin. That was back in 2009. Now, we get to take a look at who else may be still left in the green room. There's a whole lot of guys hoping to still hear their name called as the night goes on. There is Jabari Smith Jr. out of Auburn. When might he be taken and drafted into the NBA? What an exciting night for so many guys, Perk.
Absolutely. And look, this is what it's all about. It's not where you get drafted. It's just about getting drafted and getting your foot in the door. Like, you know, when you think about it, it's a dream come true. And I know some guys may not get picked the number one pick. Some guys may not get picked in the lottery. But it's about getting in. Once you get in and you make your presence.
Well, and now the Thunder, they have been on the clock. Their pick is in. NBA Commissioner Adam Silver is here to let us know who they picked.
With the second pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select Chet Holmgren from Gonzaga University.
Chet Holmgren headed to Oklahoma City. You can see him sharing a moment there with his parents. The term unicorn, it's thrown around often, but it seems to that it may be an accurate description for Chet Holmgren. How many centers can shoot a high percentage from three? Holmgren shot almost 39% from beyond the arc in his one season with the Zags, and his dad actually filmed every one of his games since he was in sixth grade. And when he joined us on the set of NBA Today, he said that he wanted to be a 50-40-90 player in the NBA. It seems like he actually has a chance to be that, Jay.
There's no question he has that chance. He's built for today's NBA. He's a good athlete, very fluid, and really, really skilled at 7 feet with a 7'6 wingspan. And he's got a very high basketball IQ. He's really, in a way, like a baby Giannis. He's not a center. He's not a low post guy. He is a perimeter player. And you can see he's got a turnaround jumper. He's got a fadeaway. He's got that little Dirk move. He hit over 40 threes on the season to go with over 100 blocks. There's been only three guys that have done that in the last 25 years. And clearly he can move his feet. He keeps his body away from big, strong offensive players that like to get into his chest. He can operate in pick and roll, both as a screener and as a ball handler. He's the total package with open court ability. And I think he's very well suited for today's NBA.
Well, he's joining Shai Gilgeous-Alexander and Josh Giddey. But the question that NBA fans have out there, well, who's his game like, Big Perk? Tell us.
Well, I'll tell you, if Giannis Antetokounmpo and Kristaps Porzingis had a baby, they'd get Chet Holmgren. Let's run the tape, and I'll explain why. When you think about it, he's a combination of the two. When I look at him, I see the Kristaps Porzingis in him, a big that's able to stretch the floor. He has a nice post-up game, face-up game, turnaround game, 15-footer. When you put him in the pick and roll, he can mix it up, pop to the three, and guess what? He shoot lights out. When I look at him for us at the Giannis aspect, attacking downhill, taking up space, and once he get in the paint, he's finishing at the rim with authority. Why they have to have me in this clip? But this is who Chet Holmgren is. Do not let the body frame fool you. He's mean, he's aggressive, and he's about that life.
Absolutely. And look, you can see him shaking hands there with Commissioner Adam Silver. And look at Jabari's reaction here. He thought maybe he'd hear his name called. Don't worry, young man, your time is coming. Might it be Houston that picks them? Because they are on the clock now. Now, the Houston Rockets, they were ready for liftoff the last decade. Remember, they made 8 consecutive playoff berths, 2 appearances in the Western Conference Finals. They had their third best win percentage in the NBA. They were trailing only the Warriors and the Spurs. But then the 2020 offseason signaled a no-go for their championship mission. You know what happened. Russell Westbrook, James Harden, they both left in separate trades. They own the worst record in the NBA over the last 2 seasons. So I'm just going to get out of the way. They do a big in Houston. They do a big in Texas. Big Perk, you are from Texas. Mm-hmm. What do the Rockets need here?
You know what? They need Jabari Smith Jr. I think you have a great piece in Jalen Green, who they drafted last year, a guy that finished the season strong. If you compare him up with a Jabari Smith Jr., the future is bright for the Houston Rockets. You have your foundation. We heard Adam Silver talk about the Golden State Warriors and how they built their dynasty and built their house through the draft. The Rockets have an opportunity tonight to continue to build their house through the draft.
And they're getting a number one pick. I mean, there are 3 number one picks in this draft. If Oklahoma City had the number one pick, I think they would have taken Holmgren number one. And clearly Orlando got who they wanted. And Houston's going to get a number one caliber pick if they decide to take Jabari Smith Jr. He's NBA ready.
You've been high on him for quite some time. As we've been chatting over the last couple of days, you have had so many good things to say about him. What makes you so confident?
Well, I don't think I'm the only one. I mean, he's an elite jump shooter and a guy who's 6'10". He's a really good athlete. He's a really hard worker, too. I mean, he's in the gym early, working out with his workout guy, working on his game. He's there before practice. I was there at Auburn several times, saw him out there hour and a half before practice even started. He goes hard, and he's an excellent defender. You know, oftentimes we say a guy can guard multiple positions. He can really do it. I mean, he can guard multiple spots and takes great pride in it. But the fact that he's an elite jump shooter, shoots 42% from three, I happen to think it's a no-brainer at this spot, and I think Houston has to feel pretty fortunate that Jabari Smith, you don't want to say fallen when you're the third pick. He hasn't fallen anywhere. Third pick in the draft is remarkable.
but I think it's pretty fortunate for Houston to get this caliber player at three. But they were going to get a high caliber player no matter what.
Right. Houston does not have a problem here, you could say. The Western Conference, though, it continues to be a tough conference to play in, Big Perk. In Steven Silas's system, how would you see someone like Jabari Smith fitting?
Well, I think it's all about letting them play in the open court. And that's the system that I see when you talk about Coach Silas. You, like I alluded to earlier, you watch Jalen Green. He was able to play freely. You watch, you know, Kevin Porter Jr. They're able to be the best version of themselves. What Steve Silas come in at is that holding them accountable and getting the best out of them on the defensive side of things. He's a young, passionate coach, well-respected around the league by his peers and current and former players, and that's why he's in stack, and that's why I'm happy for the Rockets to pick Jabari Smith, which they're about to do right now.
Absolutely. Well, the pick is in. Let's see if you're right.
Right,
you're giving it away.
Let's see if he's right. Let's hear from Commissioner Adam Silver just to make sure.
With the third pick in the 2022 draft, the Houston Rockets select Jabari Smith Jr. from Auburn University.
Hey, Perk. You were right.
I love it. I love it. H-Town, stand up.
McDonald's All-American. He gets selected number three overall. Sharing a moment with his family. His father, Jabari Smith Sr., was drafted by the Kings, actually, bounced around to several NBA teams. I had a chance to chat with him the other day, and he shared this really wonderful story with me about how he's really looking to pave his own way. He is forever humble, tattooed across his chest. You can see it right there. But he actually used to go to the Sandy Creek High School gym back in high school before the doors were even open. He'd text his janitor and say, hey, can you let me in? He'd have four peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in his backpack to fuel him throughout the day. He'd eat them then. He's the highest drafted Auburn player in the Common Draft era. This is just a wonderful moment. You can see the handshake there. Jay, what are the Rockets getting?
Well, his shooting mechanics are impeccable. He can shoot it with a high release off the catch or the dribble. He's got a mid-range pull-up, shoots 42% from three, hits 79 threes on the season, and can shoot it out of the mid-post. He gets to his spots really well. He's got a fadeaway jumper, a jab step. He can drive it either way. And a lot of people have talked about, well, he only shot 43% overall in the season. Is he a good finisher? He finishes at 61% at the rim. It's just a question of him getting to the rim more. But the offense that Auburn ran, it was kind of a flex system, and it wasn't always conducive to him, you know, getting to the rim and driving it. But he's fully capable. But I think his defensive versatility sets him apart in this draft. His ability to guard multiple positions, challenge at the rim, excellent defensive rebounder, and the fact that he's a worker and can hit those contested shots. I'm a big believer in Jabari Smith at the NBA level.
I am too, and when I look at him, I see a combination of two players. For you old heads, Sharif Abdul-Rahim, right? Able to get to his spots, hell of a pump fake, and getting to the basket downhill. And then for the younger generation, he has a little bit of Kevin Durant in his game, shooting 42% from the three this past season, getting out in transition and being able to finish at the basket because of his length and his athleticism.
Jabari Smith Jr., he is headed to Houston. But a team that is on the clock now is a team that his dad played for in the Sacramento Kings. So let's take a little look at what Sacramento has been doing over the last couple of years, right? They acquired Domantas Sabonis from Indiana. That was a huge piece for them. And then they missed the playoffs, right? They have the 16th straight season that they've missed it. That's the longest active drought in the NBA currently, but it's been a big week for them. They're on the clock right now. They introduced head coach Mike Brown as their new coach of this team, of this franchise. I want to check in with our Bobby Marks and Adrian Modrowski for more on Sacramento.
Malika, Sacramento Kings, they're focused on Iowa's Keegan Murray here at number four. There's a lot of expectation that this is a spot where Jaden Ivey would go in this draft. And now the possibility of Ivey dropping down to number five to the Detroit Pistons. There were a number of trade discussions with Sacramento and teams all up and down in the lottery. But Keegan Murray is their focus. And now suddenly Detroit perhaps has the opportunity to select Jaden Ivey or perhaps even trade down and somebody else maybe jumps up to number five. And remember, Jaden Ivey's a player who did not go to Sacramento and worked out. There were no medicals there. So when you look at from Sacramento's perspective, you know, certainly that does become a little bit of a concern. But they're looking at a guy that can come in right now in Keegan Murray that can play right away. And if Jaden Ivey is that guy for Detroit, maybe at five, they've got a steal right there.
Thank you so much. Jay Billis, for those who maybe aren't as familiar with Keegan Murray's game, what do you like about him?
Everything. They should be familiar because Keegan Murray might have been the best overall player in the country last year on both ends of the floor. You know, he went from a year ago averaging about 7-8 points a game to averaging 24. And I think he's the most efficient player in this draft and the most NBA ready to plug in right now.
Absolutely. Well, Sacramento, their pick is in. Let's hear from NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see who the Sacramento Kings will be taking.
With the fourth pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the Sacramento Kings select Keegan Murray from the University of Iowa.
Keegan Murray becomes the highest drafted Iowa player in the common draft era. Sharing it all with his family as he walks to the stage. Keegan Murray, he actually grew up in Iowa in Cedar Rapids. That's in East Iowa. It's a town with a population of just over 130,000. Lots of cornfields. Balling at Iowa, it runs in the family. His father, Kenyon, also played at Iowa and is third all-time in steals. But that's not where the family stops. He is teammates. It was teammates with his identical twin brother, Chris. And his younger siblings are athletes, too. His mom was a collegiate golf player. And then last year, he made a case, as Jay mentioned, to be the best player in college basketball. He increased his scoring from 7 points per game his freshman year to more than 23 his sophomore year. You can see him there shaking hands with Adam Silver. Jay, you touched on it. Elaborate a little bit more, please, on what you liked about Keegan Murray.
Well, we mentioned, Malika, his efficiency. He led the NCAA in player efficiency rating at about 38, which is a gigantic number. He's NBA ready right now. His basketball IQ is tremendous. Very smart. He's got a great feel. He makes really good reads, and he pursues the ball. He's not going to be an Instagram sensation, but because he's not like the spectacular dunker and all that stuff, even though he dunks a lot. But he does the smart play every play, and he does it over and over again. At the end of the game, he's got spectacular numbers. He can handle it. He can change speeds. He drives it either way to the point of seeming ambidextrous, and he shoots 40% from three. So he's a good shooter. He's excellent out of the post. He's in the 99th percentile out of the post in the mid post.
Absolutely. And I like him. He reminds me a little bit of Pascal Siakam. You know, able to take advantage of little guys when he has the mismatch, has the size and length, knows how to play his role at times, plays off the ball well, active in the deflections on the defensive side, turning it into transition points. And that's what I like about Keegan Murray is his size, his athleticism, along with his IQ and his feel for the game.
And he's got great hands. He catches everything. You mentioned the deflections he gets. He may not be the most dynamic guy staying in front of people, but he makes great recoveries.
Absolutely.
And he always is in the right position. He talks. He's got everything. It's just not he's not this spectacular athlete that's going to jump off the page. But when you look at the page at the end of the game, he's scratched in every important category.
Do you like the way that he fits with this group?
I do, especially alongside De'Aaron Fox, right? The Kings have showed us that they're committed to him and that De'Aaron Fox is their franchise player. Why not add a wing? The wing is the most important position in the NBA.
Right now.
Think about it. The Golden State Warriors won because of Andrew Wiggins and the way that he was able to play defensively and offensively. No more what the Lakers had, those cook wings. You need those young wings that sit in the sink, that's raw, that's seasoned, that's ready to go into the oven.
The barbecue wings, the buffalo wings, if you will.
No more cook wings. I don't want the wings that's been out on the stove all night.
Okay, I understand. All right, let's go to Detroit because they are currently on the clock. So Cade Cunningham, obviously, he was drafted number one overall last year. Detroit, they're still trying to figure out how to crack the East. It's become a tougher conference with Boston dominating, with the Milwaukee Bucks dominating. The Brooklyn Nets are hopeful. But let's take a look at exactly where the Detroit Pistons are now. So Cade Cunningham, all-rookie first team this last season, but less than 25 wins for the third straight season. Remember, there's head coach Dwayne Casey. The projected second most cap space this offseason. So might we see, actually it's the most after the trade, so might we see them add a star caliber player along with their pick here, Perk?
Absolutely, and I think the guy that stood out to me is Ivy, right? You can see him pairing up alongside Cade Cunningham. The great thing about Cade is that he's really that point forward type player. Not only can he get his, but he's great at facilitating for others. And I know Troy Weaver, last year he was very, very high on Jalen Green, right? He loved his athleticism. He loved his explosiveness. And now he actually has a chance to actually get a somewhat version of Jalen Green in Ivy.
Well, obviously we saw, as Adrian Wojnarowski reported, the departure of Jeremy Grant for the Detroit Pistons. He's on his way to the Portland Trail Blazers. So there's a little bit of room there for the Pistons to add some more veteran presence to go along with their young core, Perk.
Yeah, and one name comes to mind, DeAndre Ayton, right? Another man's trash is another man's treasure. And when we talk about DeAndre Ayton, we're talking about a guy that could average 20, 10, and 3 blocks in this league. We're talking about a guy that is everything that you want in that power forward slash center position. And I think Troy Weaver has his eyes on DeAndre Ayton. That's why he made room for him. And he's only 23 years of age. So he's still young that you could put him in right with the young core that you already have.
But if they do end up going with Jaden Ivey with this pick, why does he fit as for an NBA-ready team that's hoping to crack that drought for them?
I mean, if you're going with best available player, I think this is the best available player at number 5, and I don't think there's much question about it. You know, Jaden Ivey's the best athlete in this draft.
Right.
I mean, he's the best athlete in this draft. You mentioned Troy Weaver, like Jalen Green's athleticism. If he likes athleticism, Jaden Ivey's got it.
I think that might make a little bit of sense in Detroit. Detroit basketball. All right, the pick is in. Let's get it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 5th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Detroit Pistons select Jaden Ivey from Purdue University.
Kendrick Perkins is what it is all about.
Absolutely. Like, let it out. Let it out, young fella. This is about the journey. This is the necessary sacrifices that you made to get to this point to have your name called.
Well, and the first person that he hugged was his mother. And I just want to shed a little bit of light on their story. Ivy was raised by his mom, who played in the WNBA. She's now the head coach of the Notre Dame women's team. And he'll tell you they watch a lot of film together. They spend a lot of time together. She works with John Morant. John Morant, someone he models his game after. But that time that he put in with mom, look at her, making sure she captures every single moment of her son having his moment on the stage with the commissioner.
I mean, you gotta love it. This is what it's all about.
This is it. This is what it is all about. Here are some of those moments we were mentioning Jaden and Niel Ivey. He's the second Purdue underclassman to be named to the first team All-American in the last 92 years. But really, the story, the connection between him and his mom as a coach, as a player, is just so wonderful. Who has she coached him to become, Jay?
Well, a dynamic and explosive guard who is great in transition. His speed is remarkable. In the open floor, he's fantastic. He can change speeds, but he's got a gear that very few other players have. It's Ja Morant type speed and explosiveness with Dwayne Wade type length. He's improved his shooting over the last year. Catch and shoot, he can get his own, and he's got deep range. He doesn't shoot a great percentage, but he can run off screens and makes good reads and cuts with great speed. And when he gets downhill, forget it.
And we talked about his mom coaching Ja Morant. This guy has, Ivy has Ja Morant written all over him. When you talk about a dynamic, athletic guard that could get to the basket and finish above the rim, a guy that's real quick and shifty with the basketball coming downhill, and he will punch it on you and let you know about it. That's the thing I love about the kid, Ivy, Ja Morant.
Well, it's not really a surprise that he's compared to Ja Morant. I mean, look at him, his mom. I said it before, but I will say it again. She was an assistant coach with the Memphis Grizzlies. I just want to reiterate, as we continue to celebrate Title IX and the strides that women have made. That it is still rare to see that. And so shout out her and shout out Jaden Ivey. I just want to take a look at this moment again, because this, I can't say it enough. This is what it's about. Mm-hmm. It is not just a player getting drafted into the NBA. It is a journey the entire family is going on. That is the look of a proud mother, of a proud parent who says, you know what, baby, that's a job well done.
Absolutely.
And this, Malika, is, I think, where the draft gets really interesting. Because
yeah.
I do think most observers and most basketball people had this top five. It might have been in a different order, but this was the five we expected to be gone by now. What happens next, I think, is really a crapshoot. Because there are
number, in the best way.
There are a number of different, you can shoot craps.
Right.
There are a number of different things that are going to happen here that we haven't anticipated.
Yep.
And there are a number of different ways teams can go. I think this is where the draft really starts.
So if the draft really starts here and you put on your GM hat, who are you liking as the best available?
Well, you got Shaedon Sharpe from Kentucky, who's the mystery man. We haven't seen him play in 8 or 9 months in 5-on-5 play.
Yep.
But a dynamic athlete that can really shoot it. Dyson Daniels out of the G League, who is a spectacular defender. Ben Mathurin from Arizona, who Woj reported yesterday but they was being looked at in the top five. A couple days ago and throughout the draft process. So there are a number of different ways that you could go with this number six pick.
Well, guess what? The pick is in, so we get to find out which of those best available will no longer be available. Let's send it back over to the commissioner to see who Indiana is picking.
With the sixth pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the Indiana Pacers select Benedict Mathurin. From Montreal, the NBA Academy Latin America, and the University of Arizona.
Got to make sure the fit is done up right. It's a big moment for Ben Mathurin and his family. What do they say, Jay? Bear down?
Bear down, baby.
Bear down, baby. So Ben Mathurin, he's a talented scorer. He actually grew up in Montreal. His parents, though, are from Haiti. He attended the NBA Academy in Mexico City. Initially, and I thought this was really interesting, he struggled with the language barrier and communicating with his teammates. The NBA is becoming increasingly international, but now he speaks Spanish, French, Haitian Creole, along with English. He was the Pac-12 Player of the Year. And I don't know, that might be my favorite suit that I've seen all night. That's pretty good, Big Perk.
He dripping. You said it was raining outside.
You got to get an umbrella for that.
I don't know, Ben Carroll's purple rain suit, pretty good.
Yeah, I like that. The bling. That's all right, top two. We'll get back to that at the end of the night. Suit aside, what do you like about him, Jay?
Well, he's a shot creator and a shot maker. Shot 37% from three. His true shooting percentage was over 57%. Another guy with really good speed, especially in transition, and he moves really well without the ball. He's an excellent cutter. And I think Tommy Lloyd's offense was perfect for Ben Mathurin for cuts. He's in the 86th percentile in scoring off of cuts in college basketball last year. And he's a good defender, good pick and roll defender, and a guard rebounder. Averaged just about 6 rebounds per game last year for Arizona. He reminds you a little bit of Caris LeVert, but you've got another comparison.
Absolutely. I got OG and Ginobili. When you talk about his size, his athleticism, his length, his strength, being able to spot up and shoot threes, but also being able to somewhat be a two-way player on the wing position. We talk about how important that wing is. He reminds me a lot of OG.
OG Ananobi, not Moses Moody?
Not Moses Moody. Moody Moses. But OG.
Benedict Mathurin taken by the Indiana Pacers. And the party isn't just happening here in Barclays Center. It's also happening in Mexico. I mentioned he attended the NBA Academy. So the party is going global. The party is going global for him. Here's behind the scenes with Paolo Banchero, who was taken number one overall. I think you might be right, Jay. That's a pretty good suit. Yo, ghetto Banchero. We will have more of the NBA draft coming up after this.
This kid is sensational.
A resounding dunk.
Welcome to the Orlando Magic select Paolo Banchero from Duke University.
What's up? This is Jaden Ivey, and this is my first connection. I fell in love with the game watching my mom coach women's college basketball. I'm traveling more now than I ever have, so I definitely stay connected with my mom.
It's fitting that you're getting drafted in the 50th anniversary of Title IX.
The opportunity that Title IX afforded my mom as a player and then as a coach provided me with the backdrop to where I fell in love with this game.
There's no way, Chowder.
Yo, you gotta be kidding me.
Downright amazing.
Unbelievable.
That is what you call a wicked shot.
Rack him up, Chi-Town.
Stealth mode?
Yeah.
Shh. Don't PTA meetings end at 9?
Oh, got lost.
Wait.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
Try Taco Bell's new $2 cheesy double beef burritos.
What have they told you? You changed the game.
This is crazy.
What have they said you bring a franchise back to prominence?
Can't ask for nothing better than that.
What have they said you be the newest Magic Act?
And amazing.
What have they said no matter where your name appears on this board, the future is yours to create.
With the next pick.
Frosty time is kind of like you time, if you time tasted like a Frosty. Mm.
Hey, Willie, can I get a hand with this?
You got this, brother. I know you've been working out.
Please, this is pretty heavy.
That's why I got the small, man.
When it's Frosty time, choose wisely. Choose Wendy's new Strawberry Frosty.
It's the bad guy!
Get that!
It's showtime.
Aha! Gotcha!
Do I get to improvise?
This surprise.
Surprise!
We may be bad, but we're so good at it.
NBA Draft 2022 is presented by State Farm. For surprisingly great rates, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome back to the 2022 NBA Draft. And while we were in break, the Portland Trailblazers were on the clock. Let's see who our friend Mike Schmitz and company picked.
With the seventh pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Portland Trailblazers select Shaedon Sharpe from London, Ontario, and the University of Kentucky.
Two Canadians go back to back. Shaedon Sharpe, though, fascinating journey. Allow me to introduce Shaedon Sharpe, because the 19-year-old, he's been this season's true man of mystery. He's international. He's from London, but no, not that London. London, Ontario, home to a wide range of famous Canadians. You can see some of them there. And basketball, it's Sharpe's bag. So for his sophomore year of high school, he went to Bel Air, Kansas. But after a year, he transferred. He took the jumbo jet west to Glendale, Arizona, became the national number one ranked high school prospect. And then he burst onto the scene at Kentucky. sort of. You can see his measurements there, but he didn't actually play at Kentucky. He practiced, so we're talking about practice, and that's when scouts, they came to see him there. But now, exactly who are we getting? We can see him there taking his hat, heading to Portland, shaking hands with Commissioner Adam Silver. But I mentioned that he's a man of mystery, Jay. Kentucky fans hadn't seen him play in a game. So who exactly are the Trailblazers getting?
Well, they didn't see him play because he reclassed from the 2022 high school class to go to college in January. He was the number one player in that 2022 high school class. He's a 6'6 wing. He's got a 7-foot wingspan. And when I'd go to see Kentucky practice, I was supposed to be watching the team, and I was transfixed watching Shaedon Sharpe work out on his own with a coach on the side. He's a high wire act, a strong lower body, really fluid, and just a high wire act that can get above the rim, but he can also really shoot it. He's got an excellent stroke, great range on his shot. There you can see the explosive that he's got. You mentioned he played for the Canadian national team. He's just wired to score, but great potential and a really high ceiling on him as a super talented wing.
I can't wait to see him play in Portland. So I mentioned that he's from London, but not London, England, London, Ontario. So that means, look, multiple Canadian-born players drafted in the same lottery. Benedict Mathurin tonight and Shaedon Sharpe join a slew of other guys that you can see on their screen there. Shaedon Sharpe, once again, he is headed to Portland to team up with Dame Dalla, Damian Lillard. It'll be interesting to see how they all fit and gel there. But speaking of Portland, but not exactly speaking of Portland, we have the New Orleans Pelicans. They are on the clock with the number 8 pick. And so the Trailblazers, right? CJ McCollum departed the Blazers. He is now with the Pelicans. What do you like here, Perk?
You know, when I think about the Pelicans, right, it's about continue to add depth for as young bigs, I believe, that they could, you know, that they could develop.
Yeah.
You know, I like the kid Jalen from Duke. You know, I think he would fit well with the Pelicans as far as just his growth,
right,
you know, coming in and being there. Willie Green has done an exceptional job. CJ McCollum has came in and been that leader that they needed, that voice in the locker room with his play on and off the floor. So when I think about the Pelicans, I think they can't go wrong with a big at this moment.
Well, when I think about the Pelicans, you know who I think about?
Zion.
I think about Zion Williamson. I mean, like, that's who we have to think about. Obviously, we didn't see a whole lot of Zion Williamson recently. He's been recovering from that foot injury, Kendrick Perkins. To you, I mentioned it earlier, the West is just so incredibly stacked, but with the core of CJ McCollum, of Zion Williamson, not to mention Brandon Ingram, how do you see them faring in the West this year?
You know what? They're going to be a force to be reckoned with. If they could stay healthy, we watch what they did the last part of the season. We watch Brandon Ingram take that leap into, as a young superstar. And we know what Zion Williamson is capable of doing. If he comes back and he's the Zion that we saw before the injury, they're going to be a real problem in the Western Conference.
Not to mention, we saw them. I was at that game when they got out of the play-in tournament, when they made it into the playoffs. The energy that they had, the electricity that they had. This is a team that does not want to be messed with. They want to go out and have something to prove. But what's the missing piece for them here, Jay? Who do you see them taking?
Well, if they want a big guy, Jalen Duren of Memphis is the next guy I would have on the board. You know, if you're looking for a shot blocker, Mark Williams is still on the board. But there are a number of ways they can go. I mean, Dyson Daniels from out of the G League is an excellent defender.
Absolutely. And they have a couple of excellent defenders on that team. Mr. Steal Your Ball is
can't
on
have
that
too many.
Team. Hey, you can't have too many good defenders. The pick is in. Let's send it to Commissioner Adam Silver once again.
With the 8th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the New Orleans Pelicans select Dyson Daniels from Bendigo, Australia, the NBA Global Academy in Australia, and the NBA G League's Team Ignite.
Dyson Daniels headed to New Orleans. And his suit is headed into our drip conversation for sure. At 15, he was playing for the NBA Global Academy in Australia alongside Thunder guard Josh Giddey. He grew up around basketball. His dad played for NC State. He was actually deciding between the G League Ignite and the NBL, and it was a little bit of a surprising decision. He went to the Ignite. When he got there, he had to adjust to the physicality of the game a little bit, right, Jay? But he wound up leading the Ignite in assists and steals. What exactly are we going to see from him in the NBA?
Well, you mentioned it. He's an NBA-ready defender, leading the G League Ignite in assists and steals, as you mentioned. He can handle it. He rebounds at a high rate at 17 rebounds in a G League game earlier this season. But he can guard multiple spots. And his matchup, he held his matchup to 37% from the field. He's a good handler, and he's a very good passer. He's got good vision, a solid finisher. He reminds me a little bit with his size and his length. He's got a 6'11 wingspan. He reminds me a little bit of Matisse Thybulle when he came out of Washington. But he's actually a little bit bigger than Thybulle. He's not focused on offense because he's such a good team player, but I think he's a good offensive player. He's just not a guy that is wired to score and looking to score all the time. But his defensive chops, he's ready to defend in the NBA right now.
I want to see the defensive standoff between him and Jose Alvarado in the gym. I want to see that go down, Big Perk.
And Herb Jones. And again, look, they're loading up at the wing position. And with all the offensive firepower that the Pelicans have, this is a pick that they actually needed just to continue to add depth, right? You don't know if a guy's going to get in foul trouble come postseason time, because they will be in the postseason. But you want to groom them and slowly bring them along, but you got the vets in front of them that you don't have to rush the process.
Absolutely. Hey, you got to trust the process. Don't rush the process. I mentioned that this was sort of a different path that we're seeing more and more guys take, going through the G League in order to get to the NBA now. So in the last 2 years, we've seen a couple of top 10 guys be drafted through the G League Ignite. Your guy, Jalen Green, NBA champion, put some respect on his name, Jonathan Kuminga, and then now Dyson Daniels, Jay.
Well, the G League Ignite is a little bit different than the G League overall. These young prospects have different choices to make. And the idea that you can't develop in the G League has always been wrong, because all you're doing is basketball, and you're doing it on an NBA level with NBA coaching. I still think college is the best way to go, but with Overtime Elite, the G League Ignite, there are other options for development, and it's proven that it works. I mean, we're seeing guys getting drafted. We'll see how they do in the NBA. You mentioned Jonathan Kuminga and Jalen Green. Those guys have done very well very early, but we're going to see how this goes. It just gives players another solid option to develop as an NBA player.
Well, Jonathan Kuminga in particular, it was in part the system that he was put into that allowed him to succeed at this level. I know you're a big fan of Jalen Green. What have you seen as the difference, perhaps the secret sauce for your wings, if you will, that the G League Ignite or the G League provides?
Well, I think, you know, you're going against grown men, right? Yeah. So when you're in the G League and you're playing against other professionals, you're going against guys that's actually fighting to get 10-day contracts into the league. So it's a different experience. And then also I love how the transition of the coaches, right? You have more NBA coaches that's down there working with these guys, putting them in NBA sets, getting them NBA ready, working on their body, keeping them around that NBA atmosphere. I always tell people, it's nothing that would get you ready like being in the NBA or being somewhat around the NBA. Well, that's the only thing they can.
Which is a great point. But the G League, I think, to outsiders used to be seen as an insult, and it's not. It's an option.
Great.
And the development option there is a good one. It's not the only option.
Right.
College is a great one, especially now with NIL opportunities, and Overtime Elite is a good one. But we're seeing the G League starting to, you're having players catapult out of that right into the top of the draft.
Well, and development used to literally be in the name, in the title of the league. It's what it does. It's what we want to kind of continue to see those guys. Perk, you actually played in the G League.
I did. And you know, the other opportunity is that you're able, NBA scouts are able to watch guys in the G League bit more, right? They're able to be around and go to games a little bit more when they're playing the opponents. Those guys are able to come to the games and watch the other players, and I think that's a great thing too for a lot of guys that's going to the G League out of high school.
Well, we're gonna maybe see a couple more guys, especially over the next couple of years, take that path through the G League to the NBA. While we've been chatting, the San Antonio Spurs, they have been on the clock. DeJounte Murray, he's had an incredible year. I mean, 21.1 points, 8.3 rebounds, 9.2 assists. By the way, all of those Kendrick Perkins are career highs. He led the NBA. I didn't know this. He led the NBA with 138 steals. First career All-Star selection. I mean, just an incredible season for him. What do you want to see, the type of player he needs to be paired with in order to bring him to the next level?
You know what? I'm going to stay with the big, right?
Big Perk's going to stay with the big. Shocking.
Because here's why. When you look at when you have a point guard like Murray that's willing to not only create for himself but create for others, you need a dynamic roller. You need a live threat at the basket. You need a guy that's going to have your back and be able to anchor the pick and roll. You need a guy that when you get beat off the dribble, he's going to be there to protect the rim and have your back at the rim.
Big Perk repping for the big man. Absolutely. Maybe I'm the only one. Maybe I'm the only one who thinks this is funny. Perk, what's your middle name?
Liddell.
His middle name is essentially Little. Big Little Perkins. Like, that's just saying.
I don't think Little is in play here.
I don't think it's in play either. But who is in play for the San Antonio Spurs?
I think Jalen Duren, who we mentioned before from Memphis, is just a man-child. Long arms.
Perk loves those.
I mean, he can block shots, rebound, run the floor, good short roller. He's in play. If you're talking about a big guy, we mentioned Mark Williams from Duke, one of the best shot blockers and rim protectors, guy who's a great lob threat. So there are a number of different options they would have. And if you wanted to go with a wing, I would think that Johnny Davis of Wisconsin would be the wing you'd go with there. A.J. Griffin also still on the board from Duke, who's arguably the best shooter on the board.
Well, and one of the things that I've said, I'm going to sound like a broken record by the end of the night, but this is such an incredibly deep draft, Jay. On any other given year, some of these guys, they may be drafted even higher than what we're seeing now, correct?
Absolutely. I think in other drafts, but you're looking at a bunch of different guys that have different skill sets.
Yeah.
So if you're looking for a big guy or all that, I think now you can start talking about need, but I'd still go with the best available player no matter who.
And you can see the best available players there. A.J. Griffin, Jalen Duren, Johnny Davis. There's so many, but we get to find out who it is. The pick is in. NBA Commissioner Adam Silver is here to tell us who it is.
With the ninth pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Jeremy Sochan from Milton Keynes, England, and Baylor University.
What a wonderful moment for Jeremy Sochan and his family. Hey, Perk, would you dye your hair that color?
You know what? For the right price, I would. You know what I mean? I would. I mean, I'd try anything, to be honest with you.
Well, Sochan's backstory is unique. Most of his parents, they played Division II college basketball in Oklahoma, but he actually grew up in England. His late father, Ryan Williams, played professionally, and Sochan's mother, she has Polish citizenship, so that allowed him to play for the Polish national team. And then at Baylor, he was known for just that. He was known for his different, unique hair colors. He contemplated which one he was going with for the draft for a little bit, but I like the blonde that he ended up with. He's the second Baylor freshman drafted after Quincy Miller in 2012. I love this. I just love this, Jay. His mom's advice to him when he began to play, quote, be cheeky. How have we seen him be cheeky?
That's pretty good. My mom's advice was learn Italian. Jeremy Sochan is another one of these big sort of wings, 6'9". He's got a 7-foot wingspan and really versatile on both ends of the floor. He can guard 1 through 5. And he held his matchup to 25% shooting when he was guarding him. So he's got a great frame, a long reach, and he moves really smoothly laterally and obviously north-south. He's got active hands, gets steals, and really good off the ball as a cutter. And Scott Drew at Baylor used him as a point guard at times late in the season, but an active rebounder, averages about 9 rebounds per 36 minutes. played on the Polish men's national team.
Yep.
His offense, he's still a little raw. He's got a ways to go, but Jeremy Sohan has a ton of potential.
Well, and you can see, excuse me. He's not headed to the Knicks, Spike Lee. What are we doing here? But the Knicks, they're coming up. Their pick is coming up shortly. And also in the next segment, Chet Holmgren from Gonzaga is going to be joining us on set. Stay tuned for that. We'll be right back.
A lot of people assume NBA players can reach anything.
Just like they assume they can't afford great insurance. But State Farm has rates that fit any budget.
Here you go.
Thanks, John Quayle.
He's your master.
Thanks, Boban.
Need me to reach anything else?
No.
Because I can reach it.
For surprisingly great rates to fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Verizon just gave us all a brand new iPhone 13.
We've been customers for years.
I thought new phones were for new customers. We got iPhone 13s too, switched to Verizon 2 minutes ago.
Ours were busted, and we still got a shiny new one.
Check it out. So wait, everybody gets the same great deal.
I think that's the point.
Now everyone can get a new iPhone 13 on us on America's most reliable 5G network.
Can I have a phone?
For every customer, current, new, everyone, to show the love.
It's still the E-Press refresh. The Subway's refreshing everything, like the Baja Steak and Jack. Pile high with tender shaved steak, topped with delicious pepper jack cheese. Now kicking it up a notch with smoky
Baja Chipotle sauce.
Yep, they're constantly refreshing.
Y'all get your own commercial. Subway keeps refreshing.
There's a maniac who seeks to end us all.
I'm putting together the greatest team ever.
Called Valkyrie, the Guardians.
And Jane,
the old ex-girlfriend.
Jodie Foster.
Jane Foster.
Thor, Love and Thunder. Rated PG-13. Tickets on sale now.
You inspire the Lexus ES to be, well, more you. So thank you. We hope you like your work.
Are you the one others rally around? Inspire soldiers to follow your lead. See your vision clearly, get there decisively. Explore more than 200 careers at GoArmy.com.
The Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut is back, loaded with toppings all the way to the edge of a thin and crispy crust. I think I just blacked out and ate like 6 slices. Where am I? Am I in a Pizza Hut commercial? The Edge from Pizza Hut. No one out pizzas the Hut.
Good morning.
More treatment.
We're going to try something different today.
Oh, so pretty.
Dogs bring out the good in us. Pedigree brings out the good in them.
We live here in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn. Been a Nets fan since the early 90s.
Being a Black-owned business, our children get to see there's more than one way to be successful. Maybe they can do it one day, too.
Champion Black businesses as we share the NBA Finals stage together.
There are some notable anniversaries that we need to take a look at here. James Worthy, 3-time NBA champion, 7-time All-Star. That was 1982. And then we have David Robinson, 10-time NBA All-Star. I was about to say Shaquille O'Neal, but this is the 1995 MVP. And let me just get out of the way because he's a 2-time champion. And then it's Shaquille O'Neal, 4-time NBA champion. Just an easy 15-time All-Star who can also throw down and pull down the basket. Tim Duncan, 5-time NBA champion. He's a 2-time league MVP. One of the reasons that I fell in love with basketball. And then there's Yao Ming, 8-time All-Star. Take a look at what he can do. And then last, but certainly not least, let's get just a smidge more modern. It's Anthony Davis, 8-time All-Star, 2022 NBA champion with the Los Angeles Lakers. You can see it there. It was in the bubble. What a strange time with virtual fans that were actually in the building. Do you think you can pull down a backboard like that?
What kind of question is that?
All right, the answer is yes. All right, the pick is in. Let's get it to Commissioner Adam Silver. He said nerf.
With the 10th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Washington Wizards select Johnny Davis from the University of Wisconsin.
Johnny Davis is is headed to the Washington Wizards to team up with Bradley Beal and company. So Johnny Davis, he was a three-star recruit out of high school, enters the NBA after a remarkable season with the Badgers. He played with his twin brother, Jordan. Johnny was the Big Ten Player of the Year, and when I asked him to describe his game, he told me he's a versatile guard that can score at all three levels. He just loves to compete and wants to help his teammates win. That's exactly what you want to hear if you are an NBA team. Donovan Mitchell, Devin Booker, Jimmy Butler, that's who he patterns his game after, Jay. Do you see any resemblances with those guys?
Yeah, I mean, I think he's accurate in his self-assessment there because he can score at all three levels, but he's especially effective in the mid-range. I think he's a complete player, but he's best when the lights really are brightest. Against top 25 opponents, Malik, he averaged 24 points a game, including 37 on the road at Purdue. He was fantastic at Indiana, had 25 at Michigan State. Wisconsin won on the road at all those places for the first time ever, largely because of Johnny Davis and how he performed under those bright lights. He's got really good defensive instincts. He makes really good reads on the defensive end to shoot the gap and get steals, and he rebounds his position. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not a knockdown three-point shooter, but he can get his own, and he's a really good wing scorer.
All right, Knicks fans, listen up. It is your time. The time is now. Oh, see, look, the fans are in the building. They are standing up. They are standing up in anticipation of who the New York Knicks are going to pick, and somewhere Spike Lee is sweating.
They're going to boo whoever it is anyway.
Please don't fumble the bag. We're going to need security getting up.
All right, let's just take a look at how exactly we got here. One playoff series win in the last 22 seasons, and let me tell you, I was living in New York City at the time. The Garden was on fire when that happened. RJ Barrett, 20 points per game. That's a career high for him, so that's a bright spot for New York. Julius Randle, though, the former most improved player, 20 points per game, 24 points per game in the 2020-2021 season, so a little bit less productive there. Look, even the young fans, look, they're so young. They still have hope. They're excited. They are looking forward to the future. Bing bong. Do you get that reference, Jay? You get the bing bong reference.
I do.
Okay, I'm just making sure.
And I caught your modern thing before. Let's get more modern.
Hey,
talking about David Robinson, we got to get modern.
I'm just saying for us out there, I'm just making sure that the youngsters who are like, well, but what about Anthony Davis? What happened before him? What happened before he existed? Big perk. The Knicks are on the clock. The Knicks fans are hanging on every word that we are about to hear. What do the Knicks need?
You know what? I feel like the Knicks need to add shooting. Mm. They need to add perimeter play. Look, you already have RJ Barrett, who I feel like is an up-and-coming star, but you need to add somebody that can knock down shots and a combo guy, a guard, in my opinion. You know, Kemba Walker didn't turn out to what they wanted him to be last season. I think you got to add some pieces there. Evan Fournier didn't have the best season for the Knicks. If you want to continue to build in the right direction, you got to add shooting.
Yeah, if you're adding shooting, you know, we've mentioned A.J. Griffin, who shot 46% from three. I would take a look at Malachi Branham from Ohio State if you want that kind of thing as well, because I think he's got a ton of upside. And another outstanding shooter is Ochai Agbaji from Kansas, national champion. I don't know if they would take him this high, but if they're looking for shooting, those are three good shooters.
Well, Perk, you went away from your big man. Oh, my gosh. Yep. Clearly the Knicks are on the clock because it just got a little bit louder in here.
You know what? I got tired of jinxing it.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? I jinx my bigs. That's enough. I figure I'll go in another direction.
Well, again, it's getting louder and louder in here because the Knicks are getting closer and closer to picking who is going to be in the Garden next season. You mentioned Kemba Walker. Obviously, the Knicks and Kemba Walker's camp decided that perhaps they weren't the best fit. Kemba Walker was just a consummate professional throughout the season, a locker room leader. But RJ Barrett seems to be the future of this team, Big Perk.
He is, and he keeps getting better. The things that we say he can't do, he comes out the next season and he proves us wrong. This season.
Hang on to your butts. The pick is in. Who are the New York Knicks going to take? Let's find out from NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 11th pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the New York Knicks select Ousmane Dieng from Bordeaux, France.
Usman Jang is headed to the Knicks. A mixture of cheers and boos, but don't worry, young man. That is just how they do it here in New York. They ride with you until the wheels fall off. Let me tell you a little bit about Usman Jang. He enters the league after playing at INSEP Academy in Paris. He's made a strong impression on pro evaluators with his move to the NBL's Next Stars program. He had to compete against much older, more experienced pros, show a level of perseverance with his New Zealand Breakers because they were forced to play an entire season, Jay Billis, on the road in Australia because of COVID. And interestingly, you know, we always talk about who these guys compare to in the NBA, what experience they have under their belt. He's trained with his idol, Clippers wing, Paul George, but I'm hearing that we may have some news here, so let's bring in our senior NBA insider, Adrian Wojnarowski.
Yeah, Malika, the 11th pick is headed to Oklahoma City. The Knicks have traded Usman Jang, the French forward who played for the New Zealand Breakers last season, to the Thunder. I'm told that the Knicks will get back multiple first-round picks moving forward, and Oklahoma City is back on the clock at number 12.
And Malika, talk about some length now. Now you pair with Jang with Chet Holmgren, a 7'1 wingspan, guard, plays like a guard, 6'11 here, playmaker, struggled a little bit the first half of the season, can shoot the ball from three. His length, his passing, this is an upside pick for the Thunder here. When you look at his last 10 games of the season in New Zealand, 36% from three, 51% from the field. And here's another player that I got to sit down with and meet. And what he told me was he struggled the first couple months of the season because of COVID restrictions in New Zealand. He was basically locked in his room. And once he got a comfort level as far as to be out there, play basketball, which he loves, he really flourished. This is an upside pick. And now you've got two big guys with ultimate length here.
Thank you. Usman Jang is headed to Oklahoma City, which means he is going to be teaming up with the guy who just sat down to sit down next to all of us. That is Chet Holmgren, who is also headed to Oklahoma City. Congratulations,
Chet. Thank you very much.
How are you feeling in this moment now?
Can't even describe it. I got zero words for the thousand emotions that I'm having right now, but they're all very good.
Well, when you look towards Oklahoma City, just first reaction, what are you first and most looking forward to?
One, get in there, get into Oklahoma City, having my press conference, for all the fans and the fan base, that I'm going to be representing. And then secondly, get into work as soon as I can.
Well, I don't know if you know this, but our friend Big Perk, he played for the Oklahoma City Thunder. And also he is known for his famous pep talk. So Big Perk, what do you got for the big fella?
You know what? I'm just going to tell you to be ready. I know that you are. And when I say be ready, when I think about the Oklahoma City Thunder, it's a first class organization from top to bottom. Player performance, when you talk about guys like Donnie Strack, who's in the athletic department, Sam Presti has put together not only a hell of a facility, but a hell of a staff, and you're going to love it. Just pay attention, just listen to what they say, they're going to guide you in the right direction. I want to tell you this.
What do you make of that advice?
I played at 290 my entire career. When I got to Oklahoma, I was 255. So if I could, get in there and put in the work, I know they're going to get you right.
Yeah, I don't think I'll ever reach 290.
No, you ain't got, I don't want you to. I promise you I don't. Don't do it.
Jay.
Chet, did you know what was going to happen when you were sitting there when the commissioner came out and called out Paolo Banchero first? Did you have any idea what was going to happen?
No.
what was the feeling like when you heard that and then heard your name second?
Obviously, Paolo, a hell of a player. Mm-hmm. I'm proud of him and I'm happy for him. But when I heard my name, it was nothing but excitement. And I'm ready to get to work.
Young fella, I want to ask you this. Where do you get the confidence and the swag from? I love it, but like, when did you, when they finally hit that you was that guy? Because I love the way you carry yourself. Yeah, I love everything about it.
I'm just, being me out here. Yeah.
That's the answer.
You think you might get your dad a new camcorder because he's not gonna have to film your games anymore.
Yeah,
they're all gonna be on TV.
Yeah, I don't know if he's gonna need to anymore, but at this point it's like a ritual. You can't break it. So, yeah, if he needs a new camcorder, you know, I definitely think I'll be able to get that for him.
Is there a teammate that you are most looking forward to meeting in Oklahoma City?
I'm looking forward to meeting all of them, getting to work with all of them. You know, those are my new brothers. But, you know, I've been speaking to Josh a little bit throughout this process, so I'm definitely looking forward to finally meeting him.
What advice has he given you?
Hasn't been so much advice yet as much as it has been just, you know, talking about the Thunder, what they are, and, you know, what he sees in me and, you know, how we could play together.
Well, we're not exactly your dad in terms of recording you throughout this process, but we do have a little bit of behind the scenes, so just take a look over here. What do we think? What are we recording here? Is this? Oh, it's the hat.
Yep. I gotta get the hat on there. I got the whole fit together.
Yeah. What is it with these dice?
So, it's 3 and 4 on the dice. That's my number.
Okay.
3 and 4 as the 7. 7 was my number with USA when we won gold last summer. You know, I'm big on betting on myself, so I had to put the dice on the chain.
You roll the dice, you bet on yourself. What number are you going with in Oklahoma City?
I don't know yet. Does anybody wear 34?
Well, if you do, there's some interesting bets that happen in the NBA for players over who gets the number. If someone does, and I don't know off the top of my head, what are you willing to put on the line to get number 34?
I'm going to have to do some thinking about that.
Okay, but don't worry, because we're going to be coming back and asking you. Chet Holmgren, congratulations. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Headed to Oklahoma City. Thank you for spending the time.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
And very smart not negotiating against yourself on that, on the number thing.
Exactly. Don't negotiate against yourself. Don't overbid before you have to. We appreciate that. All right. Well, guess what? Another pick is in. Chet Holmgren gets to find out who may be his next teammate. Let's head to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 12th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select Jalen Williams from Santa Clara University.
An emotional moment for Jalen Williams and his family, the junior guard out of Santa Clara. He has wanted to be a professional ball player since he was 6 years old, and that is all culminating in this moment as he is headed to the Oklahoma City Thunder. He's the first prospect drafted from Santa Clara since Steve Nash was taken 15th overall in the 1996 draft. You can see Steve Nash there. 12 games he played with 20-plus points last season, tied for the second most in the WCC. Hey, that's my alma mater. What did we see in those games, Jay Billis?
Well, he's a guy that made a huge jump throughout the course of his career. He's very productive. Some people call him a late bloomer, but he's continued to bloom throughout his basketball life. He's 6'6", but he's got a 7'2 wingspan, incredible length. He's very skilled, really good in catch-and-shoot situations, shot 40% from three. He's got an excellent middle game, and he's really good in ball screens. Very good pick-and-roll efficiency, good setting it up. He can go under, he can twist it, he can snake it, and an excellent cutter without the ball, but just a really confident player that plays at both ends of the floor.
Well, Oklahoma City, they just have so many picks. I want to show you entering tonight the magic eight ball, not quite dice, but 2022, they have 3 first round picks in this draft. Not to mention, through 2027, they have 18 first-round picks. That's the most in the NBA. And our Adrian Wojnarowski has referred to this as sort of the great experiment for Sam Presti. Woj, why is that?
Malika, just the investment that Oklahoma City has made now in the NBA draft of gathering up assets and now turning them into young players. They're just 2 years into this rebuild, and you look now at the talent they gathered. Josh Giddey, their first round pick last year, who had an outstanding rookie season, and then getting Chet Holmgren at number 2 in this draft, in addition to Usman Dang and now Jalen Williams of Santa Clara. I think Sam Presti, Oklahoma City's GM, he scouted Chet Holmgren perhaps as much as any player that he has spent time with out on the road. That was absolutely their number one, the number one player on their board, and I think that was proven when Jabari Smith was available to them at number 2, and they still stayed with Chet Holmgren, But you see now that the athleticism, the talent, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, their young point guard at Oklahoma City, and you can start now to see the shape of a team that's going to be deep and talented, and still with multiple first-round picks now through the next few years in salary cap space when they decide they want to get back involved in free agency.
Woj, thank you so much. Many first-round picks for the Oklahoma City Thunder. We'll see them on the board again at 30. That was a pick that comes from Phoenix. But now the Charlotte Hornets, they are on the clock. They're looking for someone to team up with, just a talented young core. LaMelo Ball, obviously one of the flashiest players. Jay, who are you looking at here?
I think Mark Williams of Duke could be an interesting pick for them.
We know Perk's not going to jinx. He's not going to jinx him.
Am I going with the big guy thing with Perk? But for a guy that can set ball screens and roll and a lob threat, with LaMelo Ball being able to throw it up to him, and he's an elite rim protector.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of talk of Charlotte 13 and 15 maybe looking at Williams at one of those two spots.
I want to just put a little bit of context for the Charlotte Hornets here. LaMelo Ball, he was the fourth youngest All-Star ever, 20 years old, along with Magic, LeBron, and Kobe. So let's look at a little bit of a timeline here for where exactly the Charlotte Hornets are. What I just mentioned, the fourth youngest All-Star starter ever, and he absolutely earned it, but they lost early in the East play-in for the second straight season, so not exactly where they wanted to be. They hired Kenny Atkinson as head coach, but we know that has not come to fruition. He decided to stick with the Golden State Warriors after winning an NBA championship. And then there's Miles Bridges, right? 20.2 points per game. He is a restricted free agent, so we'll be monitoring that closely. I have said it before. To me, when I look at the Eastern Conference, for the last couple of years, we've been talking, Cork, just about how talented the East is, how much they are making strides towards sort of what we thought is the power conference of the West. But now I sort of see the Boston Celtics, the Milwaukee Bucks, they stand above them all. The Brooklyn Nets have a lot of question marks. When you look at some of the Philadelphia 76ers, they have a lot of question marks. What do you see for the Charlotte Hornets here?
Well, just remember, they were right there. They were right in the play-in tournament. And look, you had to have, they was four games above 500 this season. So they played winning basketball. They played together. And I love what Michael Jordan and everybody in the organization has done for us, giving the keys to LaMelo Ball. This guy's the ultimate playmaker. He's so unselfish. He makes people around him better. And like Jay said, all they need is that lob threat and rim protector. They need that guy to match up with the point guard LaMelo to be able to roll, and now he can hit his shooters and those wing guys that are spot up in the corners.
And they've made really good incremental progress. They were 10 games above the prior year 2 years in a row, which is hard to do. I mean, I was surprised they let go of James Borrego. I would not have done that, but
a lot of people where I was.
You serve at the pleasure of your employer, but I was surprised by that. They do need a coach, and quickly. Get the right next person. But I agree. I think Williams is an interesting choice.
Well, and it's so important, right, to have the right head coach, especially for young players, a young franchise. We saw that with Willie Green in with the Pelicans. He made an immediate impact in changing that culture. Accountability was a big word that he used over and over. Obviously, coming from the Monty Williams coaching tree, that's incredibly important. So let's see if they get that. They have to get that right first. They also have to get the pick right. The pick is in, so let's head to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see who is headed to Charlotte.
With the 13th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Charlotte Hornets select Jalen Duren from the University of Memphis.
Jalen Duren headed to the Hornets. And Jay, he may be the most physically gifted big man in this draft.
Well, we talked about him being a man-child. I mean, he is physically imposing. A guy who's 6'11 with a 7'5 wingspan. Solid rebounder, a very good rim protector. You know, we talked about Mark Williams being a lob threat. So is Jalen Duren. He led the AAC in rebounds. He had 3 offensive rebounds per game. He can go get the ball and get you extra possessions. He catches everything with those great hands, and he dunks everything. And I think he's a pretty good passer, especially out of the high post. He's been limited as a shooter, and he's a poor free throw shooter, but very, very talented.
Yep, absolutely. And I kind of look at him like a Bam out of the bio.
Bam out of the bio.
Yes, absolutely. I look at him as a guy that's a rim protector, versatile defender that can switch one through fives. And we talk about being a live threat at the basket, going dribble handoff actions, rolling to the basket, opening it up for other people. And he's a pretty good passer.
Well, one thing that we talked about earlier is how much experience in playing against men can matter. And one of the reasons that he chose Memphis, right, was because of the experienced head coaching staff that had guys like Penny Hardaway, Larry Brown, Cody Topper, Rasheed Wallace. But guess what? He's headed to the Pistons. So that's just in. He will be headed to the Pistons, according to our Adrian Wojnarowski. So he is on the move as the Cavaliers get on the clock. And the Cavaliers, they have had such an exciting year. They may be the team that I am most excited to watch next season in the NBA because they are going to be a force. And yes, Perk, they are full of talented big men. Look at this turnaround for them. Just absolutely incredible. So Darius Garland, Jared Allen, who used to play in this building, the Fro. They were named All-Stars. Evan Mobley, runner-up for Rookie of the Year. You liked him for Rookie of the Year, Big Perk.
I did. I mean, excellent shot blocker. He really, really knows the game really, really well.
Yeah.
Great feel. Great touch around the basket, athletic, runs the floor. But you know what? Shout out to Kobe Allman, Brandon Weems, the front office over there in Cleveland. The way that they turned this around and hiring Coach Bickerstaff, getting him in place, and then the culture, right? We haven't seen this type of culture since LeBron James was there. The way that they played last year, the way that they packed out the arena. So shout out to the front office of the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Well, they lost in the play-in to Brooklyn and Atlanta, but that was because, well, they were run down. They were hurt at that point in the season. You know, Jared Allen worked all the way to get all the way back in order to be even appearing in those games. So now, what is the piece, do you think, Jay, that'll take them over the top?
Well, I don't know about the piece that takes them over the top. They still have, a long way to go. But if they're looking for shooting, the guys I would target here, Malachi Branham of Ohio State, who I think is going to be an outstanding player.
Yeah.
And I happen to think is undervalued. You know, you've seen Ochai Agbaji mentioned in this slot. You don't think they're going to go with a big guy. You know, it's going to go. You think it'd be a wing or guard.
You want a starting five of all big men.
No, I don't. I think they have to pick a wing at this slot, right? You think they already got elite guard play. We don't know what the future holds for us with Colin Sexton, but we do know that you have a young star in Darius Garland. We do know that Evan Mobley is a young star on the rise. Caris LeVert. I mean, they plugged him in. Once he got situated and once he got into the flow of things, he was pretty great for him. Now you want that two-way defender.
Yep.
Right? Now you want a guy that you could just plug in, going to play his role, that you could bring along slowly, maybe come in off the bench, but a guy that's going to provide, give you 15, 20 minutes a game.
Well, and Caris LeVert, obviously, he had to overcome an incredibly scary health issue.
Yeah.
We're so glad to see him back out on the floor contributing for that team. He's going to be such an important piece moving forward. And, over the top doesn't mean to a championship, but past the play-in, maybe even making one of those deeper runs, finishing fifth, fourth in the Eastern Conference, that isn't outside necessarily of the realm of possibility if they add the right pieces. So I want to revisit, because this is all about the draft, your best available, Jay.
Well, the best available, I still have A.J. Griffin up there. He's probably the best shooter left on the board, along with Ochai Agbaji. But mentioned Malachi Branham, Mark Williams still available. I don't expect Cleveland to take a big guy here. And, Charlotte could grab him up at 15 next if they wanted him. Ty Washington still on the board from Kentucky. Tari Eason of LSU is a really good defender, really long-armed and athletic.
Well, the pick is in. We do not expect it to be another big, but we shall see. NBA Commissioner Adam Silver has who the Cleveland Cavaliers are going to take.
With the 14th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Ochai Agbaji from the University of Kansas.
Ochai Agbaji headed to Cleveland. I had a chance to meet his father earlier. What a fantastic family. This young man has just had an absolutely remarkable rise. His father is from Nigeria. Both of his parents, they played college ball. But he wasn't actually a big-name recruit all the way up to his senior year of high school. An assistant coach at Kansas caught wind of him. He wound up there. He started in 116 games in four seasons at Kansas. The Jayhawks, obviously the 2022 national championship champions, and Abaji was the Final Four most outstanding player, Jay.
Yeah, Malika, you mentioned it. He was being recruited by mid-major schools his senior year before Kansas got involved and snapped him up. He's what you call a 3-and-D guy in the NBA. He's athletic, a solid defender, but he can really shoot it. I wouldn't call him a shot creator, but he operates off screens, spacing the floor, and he, defensively, he's got a competitive edge to him. Shot 41% from three on 6.5 attempts per game. Good in transition. He can be explosive to the rim, a very good finisher. Led the Big 12 in scoring at 19 a game. You know, what really stands out is that 37 he had against Texas Tech, where he just made play after play when the lights were on, and he's improved as a shooter every single year. He's only a 70% free throw shooter, which is a little bit odd given what an outstanding perimeter shooter he is, but he started at 30% and wound up at 41% from three his senior year.
And you can look and see that year-over-year improvement on your screen. I just want to say, though, Jay, there's nothing wrong with us that went to mid-majors. It was just lovely and dandy. I have to rep for the WCC here. All right, that's going to do it for the lottery portion, but we're going to come back with the rest of the first round after this.
Santa Clara's not a mid-major. Hey, 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 just
celebrate tonight. I don't even know what to say. I can't believe what just happened.
It's a mix of a thousand emotions.
I thought I could come in right away and just make an instant impact.
Smell irresistible. The Axe Effect.
In the future, we'll travel to incredible places with the help of magical technology.
But what about today? I want my magical future now. I have places to go. Rocks to climb. Sights to see. And flights to catch. I can't wait for what tomorrow will bring. But in the meantime, let's enjoy the ride.
So, we're getting that house we told you guys about.
You're buying a house?
Yeah. Soldiers get VA loan guarantees.
Yeah, no money down.
Well, my office gives us free bagels.
That's cool.
Finally, ready to go. The College World Series in Omaha. Place is bouncing and the balls are flying. Next up, oh my goodness. Doing it, swinging, here we go.
The Men's College World Series continues Saturday on ESPN and streaming live on the ESPN app.
Money is power. That's why Boost Mobile finds ways to help you keep more of it, to spend on what you really want. Get three unlimited data lines for $30 a month each and a free Samsung Galaxy A32 5G when you switch to Boost. How's that for power? Feel the power of keeping more money in your pocket with three unlimited lines for $30 a month each on one of America's largest 5G networks. More power to save. Boost Mobile.
Hey, you and the Odyssey. Today, Honda's gonna pay for your gas.
Are you serious?
Is this real?
And we can help you too with great deals on fuel-efficient Hondas, like the 2022 CR-V Hybrid or 2022 Accord Hybrid.
So the lottery may be over, but the excitement is not. I want to shed some light on some first-round gems, some diamonds, if you will, that were outside of the lottery. Kawhi Leonard, 15th, Jimmy Buckets Butler, and Giannis Antetokounmpo, an NBA champion, a two-time MVP and a Finals MVP, not to mention Rudy Gobert, Pascal Siakam, DeJounte Murray, Tyrese Maxey, and Jordan Poole. The picks are coming fast now. The Charlotte Hornets pick is in. Let's send it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 15th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Charlotte Hornets select Mark Williams from Duke University.
Mark Williams. Headed to Charlotte. You can see him hugging his family there. He's not the only sibling to play. His older sister, Elizabeth, she was selected fourth in the 2015 WNBA draft by the Connecticut Sun. She used to bring him to the gym with her. And actually, she is missing a game. She got special permission from the Mystics to be here tonight. And just talk about length in this family. He measured at 7 feet, 2 inches in shoes at the combine, but get this, Perk. He has the highest standing reach, 9 feet, 9 inches, the longest among active NBA players. I'm talking bigger than Boban.
I know he could tie his shoes down the street.
He was also a finalist for the 2021-22 Naismith Defensive Player of the Year. Jay, what type of player is he? What strength does he have that you most want to highlight?
Well, the first thing that stands out, Malika, he is a shot blocker, shot changer around the rim. He really goes after the ball. His timing is excellent. You mentioned with that length and that reach, he is a presence. And getting out and blocking a perimeter shot, he can really run the floor. He's a rim runner and a big-time lob threat. You can throw it up there, and he can go get it. And an excellent offensive rebounder. Gets over 3 offensive rebounds per game. And he shoots over 70% from the foul line. I think he shot 74% this last year. So he's got a nice touch. Only guy in the country to shoot 70% from the field and 70% from the line. It's a pretty good indication that he can stretch that range out and start to make a 17-19-foot jumper in time.
And you talk about his dog mentality and going and being the beast down low, 3 offensive rebounds. His player comp to me is his sister Elizabeth. Look at this block right here.
Same mechanics,
almost the same athleticism, and the same mean mug stare down.
And the same row. Knocked into the same row in the stand.
Identical. I mean, just absolutely identical. And it makes sense because she has been in the gym with him for years and years and years, or rather, actually, he's been in the gym with her. There's the hug between him and Elizabeth.
There you go.
And his moment with the NBA commissioner. I mean, shot blocker, absolutely incredible. I do, though, want to bring in Adrian Wojnarowski now, because earlier there was a trade with Charlotte involved. Woj, what more can you tell us?
Malika, Detroit is going to send that 2025 first-round pick via the Milwaukee Bucks that they picked up yesterday and the Jeremy Grant trade from Portland. That's on its way to Charlotte for Memphis center Jalen Duren. Now, Troy Weaver, the Detroit general manager, he had two real wish list targets in this lottery. It was Jaden Ivey from Purdue and Duren from Memphis. Didn't imagine that he'd be in position to get either of them, but Ivey dropped, was not selected at number 4 by Sacramento. They were able to land him there. There had actually been conversations in Detroit about perhaps Jalen Duren at number 5 if Ivey wasn't there. And now the trade to go get Duren. And now all of a sudden you look at this rebuild in Detroit with Cade Cunningham, last year's number 1 overall pick, Jaden Ivey, perhaps the most dynamic player in this draft, and Duren from Memphis, who is a young center that could be a building block for them. This is why Arn Tellem, the president in Detroit, hired Troy Weaver from Oklahoma City. It was his history in the NBA draft. And now you're seeing it played out with the way this Pistons organization has replenished their young talent base.
Absolutely. Well, that's what this night is all about, right? It's not just the players' dreams that come true. Sometimes it's the front office and these franchises as well. And speaking of, currently the Atlanta Hawks, they are on the board. A little bit of a disappointing season for them, I would say, this year, Big Perk, just because they made, it was a little bit of a Cinderella run, sure, to the Eastern Conference Finals last season. So they set those expectations high, fell a little bit short. What are you looking at for them?
You know what? I would like to see them add, like, that stretch four. That stretch four, that guy that can spread the floor and give Trey a chance to operate in the pick and roll and get down here and do his thing, spacing.
Well, the pick is in. Let's see who is headed to join Trae Young in Atlanta and send it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 16th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Atlanta Hawks select A.J. Griffin from Duke University.
A.J. Griffin, headed to Atlanta. Welcome to Atlanta, where the players play. Basketball runs in the Griffin family. A.J., he's the son of Raptors assistant coach Adrian Griffin, who played 10 years in the league, and his sister Aubrey is a junior forward at UConn. Talk about a powerhouse. His brother played at Syracuse. A.J. actually missed a little bit of his high school career dealing with some just minor injuries, but that was a chance for him to join the Raptors when they temporarily relocated to Tampa. So he was able to train there with Kyle Lowry, with Fred VanVleet. Just a whole lot of experience there for him. He's been picking his father's brain for a while. What do you see from him, Jay?
Well, he's got an elite skill, Malika. He can really shoot it. 46% from three in his freshman season at Duke. He can spot up. He can put it on the deck for one, maybe two dribbles and pull up. He was in the 91st percentile as a shooter in college basketball last year. He's got a really good shot fake. And he's reliable on both ends. You wouldn't call him a spectacular run and jump athlete, but he's a good athlete. And his cover shot 35% this season. He's a long-arm defender that has length and strength. So he's solid on both ends of the floor, but his shooting ability sets him apart here.
I mean, surprise, surprise, Jay. Duke is already cleaning up tonight. Might they have five first-round picks? We could see. Paolo Banchero, Mark Williams, A.J. Griffin, who might join them?
Look at that smile.
I know.
I smile all the time when everybody's drafted.
Well, you know why I am smiling right now? Because Jabari Smith Jr. is here with us. First of all, Jabari, congratulations. I know this is something that you have been working toward for years and years. Can you just describe, we saw your emotions, I'm sure some nerves in the green room. What were you feeling when you heard your name called?
You know, this is something I've been dreaming about since I was 5 years old, so hearing my name called, it's like everything settled down and all the emotions came out. I told all my friends I wasn't gonna cry, but I couldn't hold it back no more. I see my dad, my mom, and it was just, I had to let it out.
Sometimes you can't help it. I'm gonna preface this by saying Kendrick Perkins is from Texas, so be kind here. What are your impressions so far? Who have you heard from within the Rockets?
I talked to the general manager not too long ago, but I think I'm gonna talk to Jalen Green soon, and just knowing they got a young core, young team that I can go in there and just grow with, you know, learn from, and just, you know, overall just be hungry and just be patient and just be ready, you know what I mean?
Houston Rockets fans, I know what you mean. They are ready, obviously, after a little bit of a rebuild the last couple of years. When I say Houston Rockets fans, I mean Kendrick Perkins. Mm-hmm. So this is your camera right over here.
Okay.
Can you tell Houston Rockets fans what they are getting and why they should be excited?
You're getting a hard worker. You're getting somebody who's going to come in with a chip on their shoulder, somebody who's going to come in and compete from day one. Somebody who don't care about stats. Somebody who's gonna do anything a team needs him to do. Is that defend, score, anything, you know what I'm saying? So you're getting a hard worker, competitor, somebody who don't like to lose. All I care about is that W, so that's what y'all getting.
I love that you're coming in with a little bit of a chip on your shoulder. You've been wired for sound tonight, so let's just take a listen to what you've had to say.
All right. I like to hear.
Even they said you was looking good, didn't
he? Yeah.
This is just,
With the third pick in the 2022 draft, the Houston Rockets select Jabari Smith Jr. from Auburn University.
I love you, boo. And you good. Yeah, I got you. I love you.
You said that you're coming in with a chip on your shoulder. I find, actually, I spoke to Jalen Green moments after he was drafted last year, and he already said, I'm coming in with a chip on my shoulder because I should have gone number one, and now I'm going for that rookie of the year. What are you going for in your first year with that chip?
I'm trying to make the playoffs. You know, rookie of the year is definitely in my eyes, but, you know, I want to win games. You know what I'm saying? That's just what that's how I was raised. That's just who I am. I want to come in and win games, and if I'm coming into every game trying to win it, I know everything else will take care of itself. So I'm looking forward to a big year.
You know what? I want to go back to college a little bit with you being back at Auburn. One of my good brothers, my good friends, Marquise Daniels, he spoke very, very highly of you. I just want you to tell us, what did that coaching staff and that program mean to your success, and what did they do for you as far as you getting to this moment?
They got a lot of people on that coaching staff who really care about you. You know what I mean? That's big in college about, you know, you want to go there and achieve your dreams, but you got people on that coaching staff who I've talked to for the rest of my life. Mm. Like Marquise Daniels, keeping my head straight through college. Like, that was my first year, so I went through a lot of ups and downs, and he just kept me grounded. He always reminded me that, you know, keep my head grounded and just focus on basketball. You know what I mean? So him, Wes Flanagan, Ira Bowman, Coach Pearl, all of them, They just helped me so much. You know what I'm saying? I thank them for life. You know what I mean? So a great coaching staff and a coaching staff that care about you can go a long way. So,
Jabari, when Malik asked you to describe yourself to Houston fans, the first thing you said was hard worker. And I saw that in you when I get to practice early. You're already there working with your workout coach. What does hard worker mean? What does that mean?
Somebody who's going to go the extra mile. You know what I mean? Somebody who always thinking that they're not doing enough. You know what I mean? When I finish any workout, I always try to do extra. You know what I mean? I always know I got a little left in the tank. So that's just the type of person I am. You know what I'm saying? Raised by my dad, raised by somebody who played at this level and knows what it takes. You know, that's just how I was raised.
You know what? I want to talk about the impact, right, and the impact that your father had on you. Like, the pressure of being being the son of a father that played in the NBA. Yep. How did you handle that growing up and, you know, embrace it as well?
It was a lot of expectations, you know what I'm saying? Growing up in Atlanta, it's like everybody telling you how good your dad was, you know what I'm saying? Everybody looking at him as this big, you know what I'm saying, role model and just this big superhero in the city of Atlanta. So just growing up, you could always hear it, and it's like, you know what I'm saying, I want to be better than him. You know what I'm saying? I want to do more than him. So that was just always what I wanted to do, and that's what he wanted too. So we just put it together, and he always raised me to just play the right way, you know what I'm saying? I always play that for the love of the game and just enjoy it. You know, that's what he got out of. So he always tried to drill it in my head just to have fun with it. And that's where my hard work ethic comes from, and just overall because I love the game, you know what I'm saying? So.
Have you already picked out the Texas barbecue spots that you're going to?
No, I think Perk can help me out with that.
You go straight to the turkey.
I mean, clearly Perk can help you with that. Big Perk. Thank you so much for the time you spent with us, Jabari. Congratulations.
Yes.
Well, the pick is in, so let's send it to Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 17th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Houston Rockets select Tari Eason from Louisiana State University.
One of the most explosive finishers in this draft class. I mean, he started his career at Cincinnati. He came off the bench, transferred to LSU, quickly evolved into one of the most improved players in college basketball. We're just saying goodbye to Jabari. His mother, I love this, Jay. His mother nicknamed him Peso because, hey, Perk, his jump shot is always money. That's a bar for you to use. See?
He was on. Talk about food.
See? And you talk about food. He was on the 2021-22 SEC first team, sixth man of the year. Jay, what do you like about this young man?
Just about everything. He's a transition wing with a 7'1 wingspan, very athletic, and is a defender, a rebounder, especially an offensive rebounder. He had 2.5 offensive rebounds per game. He has a ton of value, and he came off the bench. He was a sixth man. You mentioned he started at Cincinnati, averaged 7-8 points a game. Came off the bench for LSU, never complained. He didn't, you know, demand to be a starter. He's a team guy. He can stretch it out and shoot it, 36% from three and an 80% free throw shooter and top five in college basketball in player efficiency rating at just over 33.
And you talk about his defense and you talk about what he brought defensively. I mean, he's busier than a fox in the hen house. He reminds me a lot of Herb Jones, a guy that's going to shoot the passing lane, play with that tenacity, deny the wings, being able to switch out on and play multiple positions, one through five. I love his tenacity, and I love especially what he brings on the defensive side of the ball.
This man said a fox in a hen house. Mm-hmm. Let's take one more look at his handshake, grabbing the hat. Yeah, that is a jacket, and that is a chain.
Them
shaking
gum
hands
showing
with Commissioner
out
Adam
tonight.
Silver. You think you want a suit like that?
I mean, let me drop a few.
All right. Well, let's take a look at the three to watch brought to you by Google Pixel, Jay.
Well, three guys to watch in this draft. Malachi Branham of Ohio State, a very athletic wing who can really shoot it. Ty Washington, who did play some point guard when Xavier Wheeler was out, but a guy with a great middle game. And then another Buckeye, E.J. Liddell, an undersized big guy, long arms, can really block shots and really improved his game from being interior to perimeter this last season.
Absolutely. So we'll see which of Jay's best available go next as the 2022 NBA draft continues.
Welcome to the next level. This is the Lexus NX with intuitive tech.
Watch for traffic.
And our most advanced safety system ever.
You might think you don't belong because of what you look like or where you come from. But don't wait to see someone else do it first. Want doesn't look like anything, and it can't come from anywhere but within.
Yes. I'll get you the file.
Sounds intense.
Clients. What do you do?
Retired.
Tech?
Nah, Army.
Huh. Check your spam folder.
The best things in summer are unofficial.
Coors Light, the official beer of everything unofficial.
Kiddo was a way for me to start something for children that looked like mine. I'm trying to keep that legacy alive of Black entrepreneurship in Chicago.
Champion Black businesses as we share the NBA Finals stage together. You got me feeling like
Dodgers, Braves. Freddie Freeman returns to Atlanta on Sunday Night Baseball.
Only a pH balance cleaner, like Pledge, is gentle enough to care for the pieces you love. And those you're still searching for. Pledge's pH balance formula cleans 101 surfaces without causing damage, so you can feel great about your space. Pledge. Impress yourself.
SC Johnson.
Fishing helps ease my mind. Kind of like having Liberty Mutual. They customize your car insurance so you only pay for what you need. Whoa! Minions are biting today.
Minions, The Rise of Gru, in theaters July 1st.
Hey! Friday, we'll be heading back to Ball Arena in Denver for Game 5 of the Stanley Cup Finals between the Lightning and the Avalanche. Our coverage begins at 8 o'clock Eastern on ABC and ESPN+. All right, so the Chicago Bulls, they're on the clock. Let's look at their last season here. They made a push toward the playoffs. They were eliminated by the Milwaukee Bucks. And now their pick is in. Let's send it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 18th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Chicago Bulls select Dalen Terry from the University of Arizona.
Dalen Terry, sophomore guard out of Arizona. What do you like, Jay?
Well, Dalen Terry is a glue guy. He's like a Swiss Army knife out there. He does everything. Another player, wing, who's long, athletic, a really versatile defender, and has a great understanding of the game and how to play. It's not about him. He's a good passer, very good in transition, and an excellent cutter. We said the same thing about Ben Mathurin, his ability to cut. Tommy Lloyd, I think, did a great job coaching these guys to move without the ball, and he does that. His offense is coming. He can make a three, but just a great athlete that's versatile, can guard multiple spots, and can finish at the rim.
Well, you mentioned Ben Mathurin. This is the fifth time Arizona has had multiple first-round picks in the common draft era. You can see Dalen Terry and Ben Mathurin there, one headed to Indiana and the other to Chicago. All right. What do you think of where Chicago sits now, Big Perk?
You know what? I love them. They're right there in the middle of the pack. And, you know, adding a guy like Terry to this team is huge. You know, again, the guard and wing position, because he could play the wing, he understands the game, and most importantly, he could play off the ball, right? Think about that. You have Lonzo Ball that's over there with the Chicago Bulls, so you need guys that's able to move and cut. And Lonzo Ball also could play off the ball, which is a great thing as well.
Well, we'll see. Zach LaVine, obviously an unrestricted free agent, but yeah. Minnesota on the clock now. So let's take a look at their timeline here. It's the second time they've had a playoff appearance since 2005 this year, and we all remember the moment that Patrick Beverley jumped on the table. Karl-Anthony Towns, All-NBA third team, and Anthony Edwards, just an absolute star in the making, bright spot for them. But here's the question mark, right? D'Angelo Russell was sort of their X factor this year, Kendrick.
He has his moments, but not in the postseason. Look, when you think of the Minnesota Timberwolves, and there's no disrespect to D'Angelo Russell, he's a hell of an NBA player, but the Timberwolves belong to Anthony Edwards, okay? Anthony Edwards, and then call Anthony Towns, and then you fill in the gaps. And there's no disrespect to D'Lo. I think he'll be a perfect fit somewhere else, just not alongside those guys in Anthony.
Have you seen Hustle yet? It was pretty good. Anthony Edwards is good in it.
I mean, he's good at everything he did.
I was a fan. All right, well, this is just in, our Adrian Wojnarowski reporting that this pick will be on the move to the dark side, Kendrick Perkins. It is on its way to Memphis. Again, this pick on its way to Memphis. So, Jay, I just want to revisit, who are the best players that you see on the board right now?
Well, the list, Malachi Branham of Ohio State, Ty Washington of Kentucky, E.J. Liddell of Ohio State. Then you start getting into guys like Kennedy Chandler of Tennessee, Jaden Hardy of the G League Ignite. You know, you got some wings, guards, E.J. Liddell, more of an undersized big guy that's moved out to the perimeter. So there's some good options here for ultimately going to Memphis. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a whole lot of options. I referenced the dark side because that's what Kendrick Perkins calls Memphis. The pick is in, though, so let's see who will be on their way to be walking in Memphis and send it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 19th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Jake LaRavia from Wake Forest University.
Jake LaRavia, the junior forward out of Wake Forest. Jay, what stands out to you?
Well, Jake LaRavia has good size. He's an excellent cutter and a guy who can defend and pass. He started out at Indiana State and then transferred to Wake Forest. But what really stands out to me is how he moves without the ball. Very, very skilled as a player, can shoot it. But I really love the way he played off the ball and the way he moves without it.
All ACC second team member as well. You can see those in the green room who are still waiting for their names with their families to be called. San Antonio is currently on the clock. but Philadelphia is also going to be making a selection in the next segment. Who might be joining Joel Embiid? We will get into that on the other side.
Do you want it simple for your first job back?
Doesn't get simpler.
It's too easy.
There's nothing simple about this. I'm not the only one
doing a job on this train.
The twins?
Yeah, I'm not so sure they're twins.
You don't remember me.
Really?
Shh. Get off at the next stop.
Sounds easy when you say it.
Bullet Train.
I gotta get off this train.
Exclusively in movie theaters, August 5th.
Use only your mind. Place the order. Now.
Order up for Dustin.
I don't have any money.
Whoa. What if somebody ordered pizza with their mind?
Actually, now there is a way to order pizza with your mind. With the new Domino's Mind Ordering app.
I know my Old Spice long-lasting scents anywhere.
That's me, Mr. Cole. Let's talk about a raise.
Verizon just gave us all a brand new iPhone 13.
We've been customers for years.
I thought new phones were for new customers. We got iPhone 13s too, switched to Verizon 2 minutes ago.
Ours were busted, and we still got a shiny new one.
Check it out. So wait, everybody gets the same great deal.
I think that's the point.
Now everyone can get a new iPhone 13 on us on America's most reliable 5G network.
Can I have a phone?
For every customer, current, new, everyone, to show the love.
Stealth mode?
Yeah.
Shh.
Don't PT, meetings end at 9.
Oh, got lost.
Wait.
The Lexus RX, built for modern families.
There's no way, Chowder.
Yo, you gotta be kidding me.
Downright amazing.
Unbelievable.
That is what you call a wicked shot.
Rack him up, Chi-Town.
To look up and see those names, I know I'm in a place of gods.
We have a terrific team. We just play the right way.
But all things that are great one day come to an end.
There's a family feud over who will run the Lakers.
It was family. It carried over onto the court.
There's never enough success to go around.
That's what it is. It is the real life succession.
All these people gonna hear my Lakers secrets. Got a camera on my face.
Yesterday, NBA draft prospects participated in a number of community events across New York City. Draftees, they led youth through an MBPA and Junior MBA Youth Combine and NBA Cares Project in partnership with the MBPA Foundation and New Era. And the draftees, they ran drills and packed kits at the Players Association headquarters to benefit Covenant House, an organization that supports youth people that are experiencing homelessness. There's Tari Eason. We may see him in Summer League. It's just 11 days, 75 games. See the stars of tomorrow take the court for the first time at NBA 2K23 Summer League from the 7th to the 17th. We're going to be there, Perk, with NBA Today. Jay Billis, you're welcome to join us. Tickets and experiences on sale now at NBAEvents.com.
I'll be playing golf.
You'll be playing golf? I mean, yeah. We had to invite you anyway. You're welcome to play golf in Vegas, although it's a little bit hot. All right, Jay, let's revisit it. We showed it before break. There are several young men who are still waiting to hear their name called. One of the really interesting things about this draft is its depth. Who are you looking at?
Well, it depends on if it's a need pick, but if you're just going off the list that we've got, we mentioned Branham, Malachi Branham, Ty Washington, EJ Liddell.
Yeah.
Jaden Hardy of the G League Ignite is an interesting prospect that's very talented. And this is the range you'd go. We're still operating essentially on the first page of all of our lists. So the 19 picks have all been off page one. So we haven't had any really big surprises as far as guys moving up. You know, Jake LaRavia had ranked in the 20s. He went 19th. That's not a huge surprise, not a huge jump. Blake Wesley of Notre Dame. This is the range you could see an athletic wing who's young and and very talented like Blake Wesley going?
Park, Jay mentioned it. There's the best available, and then there's the best fit. When you're looking at the San Antonio Spurs, a group that has a fantastic young core, what do you see as the best fit?
You know what? I think you can't really pass on Jaden Hardy, right? I believe his game is going to translate in the NBA so well. He's a guy that is capable of having big nights. I'm not saying that he will come in and just be a 20-point per game scorer, but he could have those nights where he actually have 30. I could see him coming in and playing a six-man type role, getting his feet wet a little bit and keep growing and developing.
Well, the Spurs, they have really exciting players. Let's see who is going to join them, sending it back to Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 20th pick in the 2020 NBA Draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Malachi Branham from The Ohio State University.
He put a little bit of chutzpah in that The Ohio State University.
Well, they just trademarked it.
There you go. So it's important. Malachi, the first Ohio Mr. Basketball at St. Vincent St. Mary's since one Mr. LeBron James. And I just love this. He said that his goals were to, one, become the Big Ten Freshman of the Year, which he achieved, and then to become an NBA player. And now that he has been selected by the San Antonio Spurs, he has achieved both. He was Ohio State's highest-ranked commit since D'Angelo Russell in 2014. Initially, the plan wasn't for him to be one and done. But, Jay, I mean, you saw this. He slowly progressed as the year went on. He looked like one of the most talented perimeter players in the country.
I think this is a steal for San Antonio. They've got a great prospect here in Malachi Branham. Mentioned he went to St. Vincent, St. Mary's. You go there, you can never be the best player in school history because of LeBron James. But Malachi Branham, and there's LeBron James. That's back in 2002. He was drafted in 2003. That was my first draft with ESPN. It was a pretty darn good one. But he is a three-level scorer. He's got a great shooting touch, really uncommon, and a very fast learner. He shot 83% from the foul line this last year. That was second in the Big Ten. He's excellent 7 feet and in. He gets to his spots. His mid-range game is outstanding. Another really good cutter, an excellent finisher, and a really good pick-and-roll handler. As a defender, he's athletic. He can stay in front. He doesn't get a lot of steals, but he stays in front. And once he got 35 against Nebraska, you know, you knew he was on his way. In his last 11 games, he averaged over 19 points per game, shot 57% from the field. So made a huge jump late in the season, which you don't often see with young players that may run out of gas as freshmen. He didn't run out of gas. He stepped on the gas at the end of the year. I think he's going to be an outstanding NBA player. This is a great pick for San Antonio.
And what a great moment that we are getting to see now as he heads across the stage, shakes hands with NBA Commissioner Adam Silver in a fresh jacket, I might add. And Jay, I mean, you said it, a steal, you think, that is headed to San Antonio.
I actually thought he could have been taken in the lottery.
Wow.
He's a really talented young player. Is he a guy that could have gone back and dominated in college? Yes. But, you know, when you look at what even a guy like Keegan Murray, you know, averaged 7 points a game year before last, and last year he comes in and averages 24, you're going to see a jump. It's going to take Branham a little while, especially physically. He's not NBA ready today, but he's going to be NBA ready pretty darn soon. He's really, really talented in a league where wings that can shoot it and drive it and finish and defend are in high demand. He fits the suit.
Absolutely. Well, on the clock now are the Denver Nuggets. And they had a little bit of an interesting year, Kendrick, because Nikola Jokic, I mean, put this team on his back without Michael Porter Jr., who was coming back from injury, without Jamal Murray, who was also experiencing injury. We saw him become the MVP of the league for the second time. How do you see them faring next season, assuming that they get healthy?
You know what? They're going to be one of the best teams in the Western Conference. Just remember, you know, when Jokic and Murray are at their best, and Murray tends to turn it on when it matters the most. I call him a postseason player. You know, he kind of coasts in the regular season, but when it matters the most, him and Jokic really become one of the better duos in the league. And we already know Michael Porter Jr., the sky is the limit for this kid. He's a walking bucket. He's getting better defensively. And we all know that Coach Michael Malone is going to hold guys accountable and get the best out of his play.
Well, speaking of Coach Michael Malone, let's take a look at Denver's timeline here, because Nikola Jokic, I love that the team traveled to Serbia to hand deliver. Get this. Actually, they had to carry on the MVP trophy because they were afraid of checking it because they didn't want to lose it. And they got stopped because it looks like a kind of like a big glass, you
know. Somebody stopped?
Yeah, they had to stop them. So obviously they were eliminated in the West in the first round. We mentioned Jamal Murray, Michael Porter Jr. They missed a season. Yeah, they had to stop them. You can't have a big glass ball going through TSA. I mean, they put it in the PR guy's bag because they're okay with stopping him.
I'm pretty sure TSA workers know about the game of basketball and know what
they were trying to surprise Nikola Jokic, you know.
They should have put it up there with the Pirates.
So who are we looking at? We have best fit. We have best available. What do you think, Jay?
Well, the next on the list is Ty Washington of Kentucky, another Buckeye, E.J. Liddell of Ohio State. We mentioned Jaden Hardy, Kennedy Chandler, Marjon Beauchamp from the G League Ignite, and then Blake Wesley of Notre Dame.
Absolutely. Well, the pick is in. Let's see who is headed to join the two-time MVP in the Mile High City.
We have a trade to announce. The New York Knicks trade the draft rights to Usman Jang, the 11th pick, to the Oklahoma City Thunder for 3 conditional first-round picks. And with the 21st pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Denver Nuggets select Christian Brown from the University of Kansas.
I love this, when young men are in the stands and they make their way down for their big moment. And there he is, Christian Brown out of Kansas. That trade that the commissioner announced, our Adrian Wojnarowski reported earlier. But right now,
this
is Christian Brown's moment. Why do you love him?
Because he fits that system. He's excellent moving without the ball. He's a good floor spacer. And the way that the Denver Nuggets run their offense through Jokic, you need players like Christian Brown.
Yeah, he's a two-way player. You know, he defends at a high level. He can score. He rebounds. He's a good passer. He can put it on the deck. He's not a knockdown shooter. He's more of a streaky shooter, but he'll stick his nose in there. He averaged 6.5 rebounds, which almost 2 of those coming on the offensive end, so he'll crash it from the perimeter. I would say that he's not spectacular in any one area. He doesn't have an elite NBA skill, but he's solid in every area.
I love that.
And he doesn't have great length. You know, he's more in a box, but you know, he's just proven that he's a really good, solid basketball player.
Well, and Michael Malone, he likes those solid basketball players. That's his new coach. And take a look, he had a special visitor in the stands, his coach, Bill Self. That was, giving him a hug.
That was one of them hugs like, I'm happy for you, but you sure make the right choice.
Well, I mean, you want to keep great players,
yeah,
if you
absolutely,
got them.
Absolutely.
But now, guess where we're headed, Big Perk?
Take me to the dark.
We are headed to the dark side. The Memphis Grizzlies, they are on the clock. And if we're talking about Memphis, we got to talk about Ja Morant. Obviously, he wasn't able to finish out the playoffs with the Memphis Grizzlies. He had a knee injury. But Perk, this is your group, the young fellows that you have pegged to make noise in the Western Conference.
Absolutely, and it starts with this young man right here, superstar written all over him. He is the culture, he is the foundation, other people follow. And you know what? The Memphis Grizzlies has not missed in the draft over the last 4 or 5 years, to be honest with you. And I don't expect for them to miss tonight.
Well,
I really don't.
I hate to break it to you, though. This pick is not going to Memphis. It's on the move, as our Adrian Wojnarowski reported. This is the Grizzlies-Timberwolves trade. So this pick, once again, the Grizzlies will select, but it will be on the move per our Adrian Wojnarowski. Jay, who are we still keeping our eye on here?
Well, some of the players we've talked about, Washington from Kentucky is still on the board. E.J. Liddell, Kennedy Chandler of Tennessee, an undersized point guard that defends very well and really good in pick and rolls. We mentioned Blake Wesley, Marjon Beauchamp from the G League. You know, it'd be interesting. Walker Kessler from Auburn, the best shot blocker in this draft, is also still available.
Best shot blocker in this draft. Interesting. All right. Well, let's take a look and see who is going to be picked by Memphis on their way to Minnesota. Here is NBA Commissioner Adam Silver once again.
With the 22nd pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Memphis Grizzlies select Walker Kessler from Auburn University.
So for the first time in the common draft era, Auburn has had multiple players selected in the first round. Walker Kessler started his career at North Carolina. His father, Chad, actually played at Georgia, was a fifth round pick in the 87 NBA draft. He was ranked the number one player in the state of Georgia by ESPN. He's the first player in Auburn history to receive SEC Defensive Player of the Year honors. And now his moment as he shares a hug with his representation. What exactly are they getting, Jay?
Well, they're getting the best shot blocker in the draft. He had two triple-doubles this last season, and it's because of having double-digit blocks in each one of those games. You know, he averages 6.5 blocks per 36 minutes.
Wow.
That's really remarkable. So, and he's a tremendous lob threat. You know, he can set a screen and then roll to the basket, short roll, but you can throw it right up to him, and he goes as high as he needs to get it. You know, he only shot 20% from three, but he does have a good stroke, and I think he's going to be able to be a reliable shooter from the perimeter in time because he's still a young player. This is his first year really, really playing gigantic minutes. But the SEC Defensive Player of the Year, the Naismith National Defensive Player of the Year, he was just a terror around the basket that covered up the rim from 12 feet and in.
Well, and then this is his handshake, his moment with NBA Commissioner Adam Silver. I mean, serious, serious shot block. All right. Well, now it's the Philadelphia 76ers that are on the clock, and it has been just a roller coaster of a season for the 76ers. A whole lot going down. Let's take a look at their soap opera.
Tensions have been simmering between Simmons and the Sixers all offseason.
He intends to never play another game for the franchise.
This one, I don't care about that man, honestly.
Everybody would love to have Ben Simmons, but it's at what price?
The Brooklyn Nets, they are trading James Harden to Philadelphia for Ben Simmons.
This is the most potent offensive duo that this league has.
Harden, Embiid, and one counted. A lethal combo platter.
Tonight is a date that we've had circled on the calendars.
In a playoff-like atmosphere, the Nets suck the life out of the place.
No one under more pressure in the playoffs than James Harden.
And again, out hustles all of the blue jerseys. Philadelphia, for the fourth time in the last 5 years, is eliminated on its home floor.
And everybody expected Houston James Harden, but that's not who he is anymore.
All right, Perk, we have watched this unfold all year long. What are your thoughts on what transpired in Philadelphia?
You know, it was a lot, but, you know, some would call it a failed season. Not me. When you have one of your all-stars and a superstar caliber player in Ben Simmons that shut it down and basically quit on the team at the beginning of the season, they didn't mope. They didn't want anybody to feel sorry for themselves. They went out there and they competed.
Yep.
They were a top five team in the best conference in the Eastern Conference. So it wasn't a failed season. I know James Harden didn't perform like he was supposed to, but I still think their season last year was still a bit of success.
Okay. Well, we have some news, so I want to check in with our senior NBA insider, Adrian Wojnarowski. Hey, Woj.
Yeah, Malika, Philadelphia has traded the 23rd pick to the Memphis Grizzlies for De'Anthony Melton, a guard, and Memphis is going to draft David Roddy from Colorado State here. Now, they've picked up two picks, Jake LaRavia from Wake Forest in a deal with Minnesota, and now David Roddy from Colorado State. So, as expected, Daryl Morey moved out that number 23 overall pick to bring in a rotation guard in De'Anthony Melton.
De'Anthony Melton is on the move. Our Adrian Wojnarowski, thank you so much. Jay, he mentioned David Roddy. What can you tell us about him?
Well, he's an undersized big guy, but he can shoot it. David Roddy was the Mountain West Player of the Year. Another guy who's a three-level scorer, but a talented player, just sort of undersized.
Absolutely. Well, the pick is in. Let's go to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see, once again, as our Adrian Wojnarowski reported, Philadelphia will be picking, but this pick will be on the move to Memphis.
With the 23rd pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select David Roddy from Colorado State University.
David Roddy, a junior forward, 595 points last season, the fifth most in a season in program history, Jay.
Yeah, barrel-chested big guy that's got, you know, really good ball skills. You know, we mentioned he's a three-level scorer. He can shoot it. He can go down into the post. He shot 44% from three. One of the best post scorers in the draft. A good ball handler and a good passer. A very talented passer, but he's got really quick hands. Just knows how to play.
Here's some more behind the scenes of the draftees tonight, or actually now I can call them NBA players. Paolo Banchero, Keegan Murray. We have so much more of the NBA draft coverage still to come. Who might hear their name called next? That will be on the other side as we say hello to Dyson Daniels and his silver suit. More NBA draft coverage will continue after this.
The only way you're ever gonna know what you're made of is by heading into the big, wild, raging, so damn beautiful it hurts world and finding out for yourself. Were you born to follow a path, or were you born free? The new Grand Cherokee, made for what you're made of.
Shop and buy online with Jeep eShop. And now during the Jeep 4th of July sales event, get 0% financing, plus no monthly payments for 90 days on 2022 Grand Cherokee WK models.
Are you the one others rally around? Inspire soldiers to follow your lead. See your vision clearly, get there decisively. Explore more than 200 careers at GoArmy.com.
Applebee's late night, because half off is just more fun. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
The Google Pixel 6. For all the Bucks fans, Serbian fans who became Nuggets fans, Heat fans who want to get rid of Photobomb fans,
magic,
Woj Bomb fans, Top Shot fans, all the nothing fans.
Are you taking a photo of us?
Is that okay?
For that once in a lifetime shot, and fans seeing it up close for the first time. There are so many ways to love the NBA, and the Pixel 6 is built for all of them.
Stanley Cup Final, Game 5, tomorrow on ABC and ESPN+.
Only a pH balance cleaner, like Pledge, is gentle enough to care for the pieces you love. And those you're still searching for. Pledge's pH balance formula cleans 101 surfaces without causing damage, so you can feel great about your space. Pledge. Impress yourself.
SC Johnson.
You have no idea how different the game is. I imagined you were dead.
No, just retired.
I want to understand how your world works.
You have no idea what I did, who I was.
I've got 10,000 agents and a $10 billion budget. What have you got?
You're about to drive this to a place you're not going to like when we get there.
FX's The Old Man. All new Thursdays on FX. Stream on Hulu.
Welcome back to the 2022 NBA Draft presented by State Farm. The Milwaukee Bucks are on the clock, and the Bucks, I've mentioned some teams at the top of the East, Boston, Milwaukee certainly. I'm remiss not to mention Miami, Jay. They certainly belong in that conversation. When we talk about Milwaukee, though, we need to talk about Giannis Antetokounmpo, his remarkable story, a movie that came out on his rise, literally, this week. The pick is in, so we will put a pin in that thought for just a moment. Let's find out who will be joining Giannis, Chris Middleton, and the crew in Milwaukee.
With the 24th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select Marjan Beauchamp from the NBA G League's Team Ignite.
I love this pick.
Not to mention, this young man has a tremendous story, soaking in this moment with his family.
Let it out.
It has been an absolutely remarkable journey.
People don't realize what it means to get your name called on draft.
Marshawn Beauchamp, he grew up in the heart of Central Washington, 60 miles southeast of Mount Rainier. So chasing the summit, it's been something that's just, it's come naturally to him. He tried various routes to reach tonight. He attended three different Seattle area high schools, traveled to the Southwest for a fourth and final high school stop in Glendale, Arizona. In 2020, he committed himself to rigorous training instead of college. And then in 2021, the trail led him back to Washington in Yakima Valley College, where he appeared in 12 games for the Yaks. He signed on with the G League Ignite for the 2021-22 season and just was a breakout star. You can see the emotion there. Just incredible. He experienced homelessness at one point in his life. I want to bring in our Bobby Marks for more on this wonderful young man's journey.
Yeah, Malika, this journey has been unwinding. It's been to a point where at one point of his career, he thought about just quitting basketball altogether here. And he goes back to Yakima Community College, moves back home, and rediscovers the love of playing basketball. And now he's a first-round pick, so it's a tremendous success story for him. It's a tremendous success story for the G League Ignite that now has two players that have been drafted, and hopefully a third in Jaden Hardy here. But just a great story with Beauchamp.
This is a remarkable story, Bobby, as you said. Let's take a look at him heading up to the podium. This is a moment that I can only imagine, Jay, as he clearly is thanking God that he has been thinking of, has been working toward for years.
Well, you mentioned it, just the long journey that he's had to get here, and now it's just the starting blocks for an NBA career. But when he was at Yakima Valley, I mean, he averaged 30 points, 10 rebounds. He's another one of these long-armed wings that can really play. You know, he can defend. He's quick off the floor, athletic, explosive. He's got a ton of ability. But I love what Bobby Mark said about he rediscovered his love for the game and the fact that he has worked so hard and played so well for the G League Ignite and finds himself in this position. It's really just the start of his career, even though he's had an amazing journey to get to this starting point.
Well, in the Milwaukee Bucks, we mentioned Giannis earlier, just a roster full of guys that have really impactful stories. Bobby Marks mentioned the G League Ignite picks. Tonight, he joins Dyson Daniels as those picks that we've already heard. Again, just the emotion of this family. the moment that they have worked toward for so many years coming to fruition as Adam Silver calls Marjon Beauchamp's name. Just, I mean, what an incredible moment. It's what you were talking about earlier, Kendrick, in that this is a night where it's about everybody. It's about the emotions. It's about the work. And then it's about finally crossing that stage.
Absolutely. And we keep, and you brought it up. It's about the journey and the process and the steps that you had to take to get to this point and the sacrifices. You know, this young man's story is remarkable. You could tell, like, he's been dreaming of this moment. Even probably when he was down there in the G League, you know, waiting to get that his name called in the NBA draft. But these are the moments that you live for. You want to see it from his family. You want to see the emotions from him. And I, you know, it's just, I've been there before, so I understand.
Well, these are the kind of stories, right, that you see movies that are made about. But, Jay, when you're watching a player, when you're watching them go through the G League process or the college process, and then you see them at this point, I mean, for you, how does that separate when they're working through things like this when they get to this moment?
Well, on this night, it's always a celebration of getting here and getting drafted and having your next life in the NBA start. But then you got to start thinking about what are they going to be in the NBA?
Right.
Because I really mean that about this is the starting blocks for the NBA. How many guys have gotten drafted? They've done better than you think. Some don't do as well as you think. And this is the starting block.
Absolutely. It's the starting block for all of these young men as we hear their names called. And we're about to hear another as the San Antonio Spurs pick is in. Let's send it back to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
With the 25th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Blake Wesley from the University of Notre Dame.
Blake Wesley selected. He's from South Bend, Indiana. He wasn't actually ranked in the ESPN 2021 100. He was a four-star recruit, though, then led Notre Dame in total points and steals. Jay, what do you like about him?
Just about everything. I mean, he's a terrific young man. His dad played at Ball State. He comes from a basketball background, but he can get his own shot. You know, he's athletic, he's got a great burst, and he plays with energy and intensity. He only shot 30% from three, but he does have a good stroke that just needs some work to get more consistent. And he's got very good defensive potential. He reminds me a little bit of Bones Highland from BCU. But coming out, he's certainly much younger and not a finished product. But the fact that he's so athletic and he's got the skills to create on his own. Well coached by Mike Bray at Notre Dame and just a really good prospect coming into the league.
Well, you can see the Spurs picks tonight. They've had a handful in this first round. And one of those players, we have their coach here tonight, Scott Drew. Thank you so much for joining us here on our set. I mean, I'm just going to get
hey,
out of the
I
way.
Got, I got Perk, I got Jay. Hey, all I know is the Bears had a good year if we're on this stage, baby. Back-to-back top 10 picks. We get to keep Jeremy close to home. The Spurs, 2 hours and 45-minute drive. 2.5 from Magnolia. You know about that.
The already timing the drive.
And we got more. Kendall Brown, hopefully James Akinjo. We'll wait and see what happens.
What is it like for you as you hear these young men? I mean, you've heard it before, but every year I imagine that it is special.
Well, just like you guys said up here, it's so hard to get your name called. And the emotion, excitement, adrenaline when they do. And we coach to see them reach their goals and dreams. So being here and supporting them, it's a great night for us.
And with Jeremy Sochan, you know, I was a little surprised he got taken that high, but his talent level demands it.
Yeah.
You know, you used him as a point guard at times, especially in that Kansas game. What do you think his ceiling is? What can he bring in the NBA?
Well, first of all, both of us are envious of his hair. I mean, he
all the different colors. He leads the league in hair color.
And see, that's part of his versatility. You know, I mean, he's versatile on the court, off the court. But his versatility, I mean, what he can do defensively, guard one through five, offensively play 1 through 5, just like Pop always wants, fundamentally sound guys. You know, our strength coach wants us to bring in guys like Perk so that it looks like he's doing a good job. You know, when you bring in a fundamentally sound player, it looks like us coaches know what we're doing.
I don't know, whatever coffee that you were drinking tonight, can we have a little bit? Because
your tea
love
up here is the
energy.
Money. Yeah, I'm just telling you.
You love your energy. Well, we had Jeremy Sohan wired for sound here tonight. Let's take a listen to what he had to say.
Yeah, it's getting real. We're excited, though, you know. So it's a one-time thing, so I got to stay in the presence, be with my family, and just have fun. My heart rate is going crazy.
Let's take a look at the night.
I love you, man.
I love you.
This is crazy.
I know.
It's love.
I mean, that is just so wonderful.
Hey, by the way, that's how we dress for class at Baylor, you know?
Can we all get matching ones? I think that would be a good look. We'd look good in lavender. I think we could do that. But Coach, what piece of advice do you give your players on draft night?
Well, first, to get to draft night, you got to get better each and every day. Draft night, you enjoy it. Be with family, friends, and loved ones. And like you said, it's the beginning. And it's just the start of the process.
Absolutely.
So, anyway, we're excited. He's close to home to be able to see it.
Absolutely. It's the start of the process. The next pick is in, so we're going to send it back to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver. Thank you so much for spending a little bit of time with us.
Thank you, guys.
Great seeing
you.
Night.
You too.
We have another trade to announce. The Charlotte Hornets trade the draft rights to Jalen Duren, the 13th pick, to the New York Knicks for a conditional first-round pick and for 4 future second-round picks. With the 26th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Dallas Mavericks select Wendell Moore Jr. from Duke University.
Wendell Moore Jr. on his way to Dallas. 13.4 points per game, 5.3 rebounds. Jay, I know his versatility stood out to you.
He's just an all-around workhorse. You know, a veteran presence on the Duke team last year that stuffed the stat sheet in every category. Really productive. You know, he shot the ball from all 3 levels. A very good passer, one of the top assist guys in the ACC. You know, he could lead the break. 25% of his points came in transition. And he's a good spot-up shooter. Almost half his attempts were in that area, and he's a playmaker. You know, leading that team in assists, he had a 2-to-1 assist turnover ratio, and he's a very solid defender.
Well, he's the 4th Duke player to be taken in this round, which would match the 1999 draft for the most first-round picks from the school in the common draft era. What do you think of that, Jay?
I like it.
That might be the case.
They started 5 NBA players. They had a darn good team.
Yeah, absolutely, they did. Well, you know who else has a darn good team? The Miami Heat. It is all about the Heat culture. They are on the clock now. I was remiss not to put them toward the top when I was mentioning the Celtics, when I was mentioning the Miami Heat. What is it, Perk, about that Heat culture that we hear so much about that just develops these young players?
You know what? It starts at the top, right? Eric Spoelstra, you look at his story, right? He started at the bottom, worked his way all the way up to the top to head coach, and now one of the best head coaches in the game. And then you look at we call him an OG or big brother, Udonis Haslem,
yep,
right, who contains and holds that locker room accountable, who's the extension of their coaching staff. And by the way, when your front office like Pat Riley have your back the way that they do Eric Spoelstra, it goes a long, long way for us holding guys accountable and making sure guys are ready.
Well, let's take a look at the Miami Heat's journey this season because they were the number one seed in the Eastern Conference. They had 53 wins. That's the most since 2014. And then Tyler Hero, he caught some heat at the beginning of the season for saying he should be in the same conversation with guys like Luka Doncic. Well, then he went on to win Sixth Man of the Year. They reached the East Finals for the 2nd time in 3 seasons. They lost in a thrilling Game 7 to the Celtics. Jay, when you have a young player coming out of college, coming out of the G League, and they're put into this established system like the Miami Heat, how does that separate these players?
Well, you're going to emulate what you're around. So, I mean, I used to have a coach that jokes, you know, you put a player in a locker room full of knuckleheads, you're going to get a knucklehead out at the end of it. But that's a locker room full of winners. I think Miami's culture is great because they measure their body fat every 5 minutes.
I don't want to be there. I don't want to do that.
Thankfully, they don't do that for broadcasters.
See, yeah, because we're going to Shake Shack after this.
You're darn right.
Well, you know, it's one of the things that's open after all of this is done. Again, I know I've asked you a couple of times, but when you're looking sort of at who you might see as a fit here, who would you be taking?
Well, if you're looking at best available, you know, we've talked about some of these players, whether it's E.J. Liddell from Ohio State, you know, Jaden Hardy, the G League Ignite. There are, you know, you got some foreign players, too. Nikola Jovic from Serbia.
Not Jokic.
Still, yeah, not Jokic. That'd be a good pick there, too, if you could get him. But he's still on the board. Bryce McGowan's from Nebraska is still on the board. You know, I think there's an interesting player still available and maybe available in the second round. It's Christian Coloco from Arizona, who is not just a shot blocker. He can guard and switch off on perimeter players and stay with them for a whole possession. He doesn't just guard them for two dribbles.
But, Jay, you know it's still one more Duke guy on the board, Trevor Keel.
Yeah, Trevor
right?
Keel.
You don't want Trevor to get all the Dukies out the way. But you know what? I think when I look at, again, I'm going to keep harping on Hardy. I think he's a guy that could come in and have immediate impact. I think he's a elite scorer. His game will adjust to the league. And I think, you know, if he could get drafted, if the Miami Heat actually picks him, he's a guy that will come in and fit in right away for his impact in the game. I mean, he's that special in my opinion. I really like this.
And I wonder where a guy like Andrew Nembhard of Gonzaga is going to wind up, because I think he's the best passer in this draft. He may not be a spectacular athlete, but he knows how to play. And Miami does covet guys that know how to play. I'm not saying he should go in this spot, but I'm going to be interested to see where he winds up in this draft, because I think he's a valuable asset.
Well, Miami Heat covets guys who know how to play and who are willing to play hard. Mm-hmm. That is such a fundamental part of what the Miami Heat do. Let's take a look at some of their key players that are down in Miami. I mean, we know them. It's Kyle Lowry, Tyler Hero, Jimmy Butler, and Bam. What do you say, Perk? Bam out of the bio?
Bam out of the bio.
Bam out of the bio. Bam. Yeah. Autobio. I see exactly what you mean there. But he's another player who, you know, in the playoffs, we saw him take some steps forward and then towards the Eastern Conference Finals struggle a little bit to find his rhythm. He said, I know that the team goes sometimes as I go. When I can find my offensive rhythm, because, Jay, he had no problem on defense. It was finding that offensive rhythm that he needed a little bit of help with.
Yeah, I mean, but, you know, one thing about Bam is that the thing that I love about him is that he holds himself accountable. And I love Eric Spoelstra has said after one game in the postseason, we don't need Bam to be aggressive for us offensively to look to score for himself, but to make others around him better. And that's one of the underrated things about his game. We look at his points and we say, hey, he could go out there and get you 18 to 20 a night, and we know he could rebound at an extremely high level, but he's a guy that could go out there and get you 5 to 10 assists. Hell, he could get a triple-double if he wants to just off his playmaking ability.
And that's something Miami evaluated when he was at Kentucky that I'm not sure I saw, is that how high level a passer Bam Adebayo was.
Well, let's see who is headed down to South Beach. The pick is in. Let's send it back to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see who exactly it is.
I have another trade to announce. As part of a trade to be finalized later, the Philadelphia 76ers are trading to the Memphis Grizzlies the draft rights to David Roddy, the 23rd pick. And with the 27th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Miami Heat select Nikola Jovic from Belgrade, Serbia.
Don't surprise me one bit.
Why not, Big Perk?
Because we know he's a sniper. We know he's a shooter.
Nikola Jovic. He was born in England. He moved to Serbia at 9, and he started playing basketball at 13. Jay, what will make him successful, do you think, in the NBA?
He's super skilled at that size. He can shoot it. He can put it on the deck, and he can pass it. You know, he's unusually skilled at that size.
Bobby Marks has been entrenching himself with these international players. Bobby, what have you seen from him?
Well, Malika, as you said, he didn't start playing basketball until he was 13 years old. He is a former water polo player, grew 8 inches in the last 5 years here, and has the skills of a point guard. He's got length to shoot over smaller defenders here. You could put him on the court right now. And at the FIBA U19s a year ago, shot 36% from three, made all tournament team here. Another nice pickup for the Miami Heat. Something they lacked when you got into the playoffs is that stretch four that can kind of come off the bench and make shots for you.
Well, some fans may be rubbing their eyes like, wait, I've seen a similar name to that before. That's because there's another notable Serbian player, a two-time MVP, in fact, that sounds a little bit like him. That would be Nikola Jokic, not to mention Bogdan Bogdanovic. And you can see some notable Serbian players who played in the NBA, both past and present. Well, now it is the defending champs, the Golden State Warriors, who are on the clock. So let's take a look here at their roller coaster ride that has been the last couple of seasons. Because remember, they reached extreme highs. That's always the fun part of the roller coaster. And then there are some extreme lows, too. But first, let's go back to 2009, drafting Steph Curry, and then a couple of years later, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, the Splash Brothers are born, they hire Steve Kerr, and a year later, they win an NBA title, and then they bring in Kevin Durant. They won two more NBA championships, so this is when we start calling them a dynasty, but then he heads to the Brooklyn Nets, injury bugs hit within the Warriors. Klay Thompson misses time. Steph Curry misses time. Draymond Green is really the only one out of the big three who is on the floor. And then they bring in Andrew Wiggins, who so many thought was going to be just a trade piece for this team. But all of a sudden, he was playing a significant role in their journey to winning an NBA championship. You can see them enjoying the parade in the streets of San Francisco for the first time, not in Oakland anymore. Klay says, count them, Captain Klay. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see the Curry family. Draymond Green showing the youngster JTA how it's done in the Bay. Mac Dre. Sorry, can you not tell him from the Bay?
Yeah.
That's how that all went down. Yeah. But Jay, what's so interesting about the Golden State Warriors is that so much of their talent, yes, they acquired Kevin Durant. Yes, they acquired Andrew Wiggins. But they have drafted from the ground up so much of their talent that is unique in this current NBA. Why is that, and what made them so successful there?
Well, I think Golden State understood, all the teams understand it, that you have to build through the draft, and they did it methodically, and they made good decisions without having top five picks every time. You know, they took Steph Curry at number 7.
Yeah.
You know, I think it was 2009.
Yes.
They took Klay Thompson 11th. And then got Draymond Green 35th in the second round. They've just made good decision after good decision. They wound up getting James Wiseman. They've drafted Jordan Poole. They've drafted extraordinarily well. When they've been at the end of the first round, when they've been in the lottery at the top of it, all that, their decisions have been great. You got to give great credit to Bob Myers and Mike Dunleavy, their whole staff, that have just made spectacularly good decisions and good fits.
Yeah. Strength in numbers seems to be more than just a mantra for them. They're able to find these players sometimes deep into the first round, even into the second round, with Draymond Green, who says, fascinatingly, that he remembers every single one of the players who was picked before him. But you can see, look, that's Draymond Green, who's at the draft headquarters saying, hey, I just want to make sure who's coming to us, what kind of culture are we building here. He'll go tape a podcast probably after this to let all of us know his thoughts on who will be his new teammate. There's Steve Kerr. You can see him as well, but the pick is in. So let's send it to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see who will be joining the defending champions.
With the 28th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Golden State Warriors select Patrick Baldwin Jr. from the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee.
He was a huge high school recruit, Jay.
Yeah, Patrick Baldwin Jr. out of Milwaukee played for his father last year, and he did not have a very good year. But all his numbers are good. He's 6'9", he's got a 7'2 wingspan. Very, very talented. He was expected to be a lottery pick after his freshman year, but he was injured, didn't play much, and really struggled in his first year. But that doesn't mean he doesn't have talent, because injuries really caused him to miss most of the season. He's got good mechanics on his shot, a high release, and another guy that moves really well without the ball and can see the floor very well. So the foundation is there. He did have some lapses last year. He got passive at times, but the talent and the foundation is there. And we just talked about Golden State making good decisions. Clearly, they see the talent that's underneath the performance that didn't match up to the talent this year at Milwaukee.
Well, maybe that makes Golden State a perfect place for him to land because of the care and the time they put into development. We've seen that with blending these young players and these seasoned champion experienced vets. We will be right back with more from the 2022 draft.
NBA Draft 2022 is presented by State Farm. For surprisingly great rates, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You know that show I was telling you about?
Yeah,
I was so close to the stage when I saw her, and
she pulled me in. Wasn't expecting that. It was
literally the greatest thing I've ever seen.
It was such a scene, but I looked pretty hot.
It's so hot, I mean, the look on his face.
Face it. You really missed out on the
best time of our lives. You really have to be there.
When you're with Amex, you always have a story to tell. It's never a question of if it's going to happen, it's when.
It's time to unleash your thirst for trying, to ignite new passions, rekindle old ones. You see, trying is what gives life flair. So try Gold Peak, then try something else. Because tea is for trying, and fire is for finding your groove in the kitchen.
You inspire the Lexus ES to be, well, more you. So thank you. We hope you like your work.
So we're getting that house we told you guys about.
You're buying a house?
Yeah. Soldiers get VA loan guarantees.
Yeah, no money down.
Well, my office gives us free bagels.
That's cool.
Celebrating 100 years of center court at the championships. Wimbledon on ESPN and ESPN Plus.
This is Her Growing Hands in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. I want to provide a space where people can just let their hair down. Healthy, natural hair care is my platform. That's why I really do what I do.
Champion Black businesses as we share the NBA Finals stage together.
Pay for your gas.
Are you serious?
Is this real?
And we can help you too with great deals on fuel efficient Hondas like the 2022 CR-V Hybrid or 2022 Accord Hybrid.
It's time for tonight's first selfie, brought to you by Google Pixel, the official fan phone of the NBA. Oh, hey, Jabari. Nice. I see you working your angles a little bit there. Good work. All right. Let's take a look at this well-traveled pick, shall we say. It has bounced around a whole bunch of times, as you can see our Adrian Wojnarowski's reporting there on the screen. But ultimately, it will end up with the Timberwolves. You can see all of the details and exactly how it is shaking out there on your screen, what the Rockets receive, what the Mavs get, the Timberwolves. But now the Grizzlies are on the clock, and their pick is in. Let's send it to Commissioner Silver.
With the 29th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Memphis Grizzlies select Ty Washington Jr. from the University of Kentucky.
And the Grizzlies just keep on winning. The dark but they're going to Minnesota.
Ty Washington, you can see him there celebrating with his family. His mom is his inspiration. You can see him hugging his agent, Kevin Bradbury, there. But his mom, battling diabetes, she actually got on a portable dialysis so she could attend his games, so that she could be here. He's quite the locker room guy at Kentucky. He's also incredibly competitive. He was the 14th ranked prospect on the 2021 ESPN 100. And when he was at Kentucky, he wore number 3 because of one Mr. Allen Iverson, Jay.
Well, Ty Washington has an excellent mid-range game. He's got a great runner, floater. He can pull up. And a pretty low error rate. He had about a 2.5-to-1 assist turnover ratio, but he shot 52% on his runners and floaters. You know, one thing we talked about, Johnny Davis earlier, and how he performed against top 25 competition. Now, Ty Washington got hurt during the year, but he didn't perform quite as well against top 25 teams, averaged under 10 points, 35% from the field, and only 22% from three. But when Xavier Wheeler went out with an injury, he stepped in and had 17 assists in his first game as a point guard. That broke a Kentucky single game record that was held by John Wall. So Ty Washington, I think it actually mitigates in his favor that Tyrese Maxey and Emmanuel Quickley did so well in the NBA early on in their careers, that, you know, you go in, you play a role, you play within a team concept under John Calipari. Is Ty Washington capable of more in the NBA? I think he is.
Well, and he was wearing, obviously, the Memphis hat, but he is on his way to Houston, Big Perk.
I like it. He's going to go fit right on in with the Houston culture. They're building something with the Rockets. I was very critical of them about 2.5 years ago, but now I see the vision, right? They're starting with the foundation. I think this was a steal for them. He's going to work well, player development. Shout out to the H-Town for holding it down.
Well, not to mention Steven Silas just has been a wonderful person to work with and to watch him coach and start to mold these young men down in Houston. Once again, the Oklahoma City Thunder. I feel like we've talked about them all night, Jay. This was already on the move, though, right? So we can look at the details. Our Adrian Wojnarowski is reporting on the screen. This is what the Thunder received. This is what the Nuggets received. We are at the end of the first round. How do you think teams are looking when they're looking at this sort of level of player? How do they make these decisions, Jay?
I think they're still looking for the best available player, but sometimes at the end of the first round, you don't want to say take a flyer, but you might want to take a player that's got significant upside.
Yeah.
I mean, you saw Golden State take Patrick Baldwin Jr., who didn't perform well last year. I think everyone would agree, but the foundation is there for him to get way better. And he's got the skill set to be way better. Are there players like that have tremendous upside value at the end here that you're not too worried about, you know, because you're using the 30th pick on him? You know, upside is something you're looking for here.
Well, the pick is in, so let's send it back to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver to see who will be rounding out the first round of the 2022, I get it, Commissioner, NBA Draft.
With the 30th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select Peyton Watson from UCLA.
What do you like about Peyton Watson, Jay?
Well, just what we talked about, the upside potential. Peyton Watson, another guy who's 6'8", has a 7-foot wingspan, McDonald's All-American, but you know, he's projected to be an excellent player. He didn't show it as much at UCLA last year, but he's a skilled player that's got good athleticism, solid on the defensive end, only shot 23% from three. But he can be a high flyer that can finish and a lob target. He was able to block some shots in the minutes he got at UCLA, but he played on a veteran team. And so physically, he's not there yet. He's a longer-term project. you know, you could argue that he might have been better off going back to UCLA and trying to become a dominant college player before he came into the NBA. But that's exactly what we were just talking about with Patrick Baldwin Jr. and Peyton Watson, going with the upside rather than the productivity that they had out of college.
Well, you can see him making his way down from the stands. I love when players who have come all the way, even though they're not in the green room, to make sure they get their moment on stage with the commissioner. You can see him there getting his. And once again, this is On the Move.
That concludes the first round of the NBA draft. Thank you to the passionate fans here at Barclays Arena. The second round will be conducted by Brooklyn native and Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum. Enjoy the rest of the evening, and thank you very much.
I want to bring in our front office insider, Bobby Marks, who has more on the last pick, Peyton Watson.
Yeah, Malika, Jay hit it right on the head. This is an upside pick, and when you're Denver picking at 30, you can take the risk on taking a player that averaged 12 minutes a game, 3.3 points a game. That is the fewest amount of any first-round pick that we have seen here. So this is going to take a little bit of a while, but when you have a Denver team that has the MVP, the reigning MVP back-to-back years, and Jamal Murray and Michael Porter Jr., a playoff team, you can wait. And this player is certainly worth the wait, only 19 years old, a 7'1 wingspan.
Thanks, Bobby. That's exactly what Jay was talking about, right? It was the fact that we have time, these teams have time toward the end of the draft to develop potentially, or the end of the first round, rather, to develop these players. Take a look, though, at the draft headlines as the first round wraps up. The Magic, they selected Paolo Banchero, a little bit of a surprise, number one overall, but that surprise, that magic, that is what draft night is all about. And then four Duke players, Jay likes this, selected in the first round, that is tied for a program record, not to mention the third time the two Canadians taken in the lottery since 1985. But there are plenty of good guys still on the board here, Jay.
E.J. Liddell thought would be a first rounder. He's in the second round now. Kennedy Chandler, Tennessee. Perk, we've talked about Jaden Hardy from the G League Ignite. There are a number of players. Trevor Keels, who has first round talent. Same thing with Bryce McGowan's from Nebraska. Christian Coloco of Arizona still available. And Scott Drew was just up here. Kendall Brown of Baylor, another upside pick. An interesting player from Toledo, Ryan Rollins. And then Justin Lewis from Marquette. I think those guys could go early in the second round.
Well, so that means get your drinks, get your popcorn, because we still have so much more to come, including hearing from the number one pick, Paolo Banchero. That is coming up, as well as the second round after this.
The next pick in the NBA draft is Johnny Davis.
The Toasted Cheddar Chalupa is back, only at Taco Bell.
Welcome to the next level. This is the Lexus NX with intuitive tech.
Watch for traffic.
And our most advanced safety system ever.
The Minions are coming to IHOP with an all-new menu you're going to love. Excuse me.
Enjoy the Minions menu at IHOP. For a limited time, kids eat free and catch Minions The Rise of Gru.
Dip into Typhoon Cove. The metro area's most outrageous indoor
water
park. Hey,
Carl.
Yeah?
We're doing Snickers. We did the water park yesterday.
You didn't invite me?
We didn't actually go to...
Was it fun?
Never mind, Carl.
Yes. I'll get you the file.
Sounds intense.
Clients. What do you do?
Retired.
Tech?
Nah. Army.
Huh. Check your spam folder.
Ooh, that looks spicy. Yeah, you got a little heat to ya. Yeah, little kick, little zing, little spice, little razzmatazz.
KFC spicy chicken sandwich. Always served hot and crispy. That's finger licking good.
To look up and see those names, I know I'm in a place of gods.
Hey! We have a terrific team. We just play the right way.
But all things that are great one day come to an end.
There's a family feud over who will run the Lakers.
Whose family?
It carried over onto the court.
There's never enough success to go around.
That's what it is. It is the real life succession.
All these people gonna hear my Lakers secrets. Got a camera on my face.
Oh, you're doing it wrong, man.
What's wrong with action figures?
Nothing, except buying them without Capital One Shopping.
What's that, Samuel, Mr. L. Jackson?
Capital One Shopping instantly searches for available coupon codes and automatically applies them. Just download it to your computer.
Whoa, you're my hero.
Yeah, I can tell.
You like it?
I look good in miniature. Capital One Shopping is kind of genius.
What's in your wallet?
I don't say it like that, Devin.
Once I did tell my story, the whole world knew about it.
We're still fighting for equality. We're still fighting for respect.
We get a chance to play something that we've always wanted to play.
The best things in summer are unofficial. Coors Light, the official beer of everything unofficial.
This is the day. I can't believe I'm here.
Welcome to the 2022 NBA Draft.
Filled with the next generation of NBA stars.
This is one of the best moments of my life.
I was praying that the New York Knicks would be up just to get you. Welcome
to the future. This is what it's about. It is not just a player getting drafted into the NBA. It is a journey the entire family is going on.
I can't believe I'm here.
Welcome back to the second round of the NBA draft presented by State Farm. We're going to send it to NBA Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum to kick us off in the second round.
Good evening, everyone. It's always good to be back in my hometown of Brooklyn, New York. Thank you for joining us for the second round of the 2022 NBA Draft as we continue to welcome these young men into the NBA family. And remember, every pick matters. For example, this year's back-to-back MVP, Nikola Jokic of the Denver Nuggets, was the 41st pick in the 2014 NBA Draft. So here we go. With the 31st pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Indiana Pacers select Andrew Nembhard from Aurora, Ontario, and Gonzaga University.
Another zag off the board, Jay.
Well, Andrew Nembhard is a big lead guard. He averaged about 12 points per game, but he averaged 6 assists per game. He's got the ability to facilitate. He can be a scorer and a passer, and he's an elite passer. In pick and roll situations, he is surgical. I mean, he comes off, makes great reads, reads the primary, the secondary, the tertiary defender, and he's a very good on-ball defender that defends pick and roll very well. Very good at getting deflection. Started his career out of Florida, and one of the criticisms of him at Florida was he didn't play fast enough. Then he goes to Gonzaga, and he was with one of the most high-powered offenses and ran the break. He's a good player. I thought he could have easily been a first-round pick, but this is a good pick, I think, to start the second round.
Well, that's what Mark Few does. All right, the Orlando Magic, they are now back on the clock, and we saw them have the number one pick where they drafted Paolo Banchero, and earlier he stopped by with our friends on the ABC set.
The guy that's joining us on the set right now, that is the number one pick overall, Paolo
Banchero. No mystery here.
No mystery. Well, you know, it was a mystery for a lot of people, including Paolo yourself, on who was going number one. When did you find out that the Magic were going to take you number one?
Yeah, you know, so 5 minutes before, you know, they were on the clock, my agent just told me, you know, be ready for anything, you know. He wasn't sure about anything, but he just told me be ready. And then probably like 20, 30 seconds before the commissioner, you know, walked out to announce the pick, you know, he looked at me and said congratulations. So that's how it happened.
So as a number one pick, as a face of a franchise, so many times people are going to talk about things that happen on the floor. But I believe one of the reasons why you went number one is the things you're going to bring off the floor and in the locker room. Talk about that side of what you plan on bringing to the table in Orlando.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel like, you know, I'm a great leader, and I don't force it upon anybody. You know, I'm just a guy who's, you know, going to get along with all the guys in the locker room, but also have a competitive mindset and bring a winning attitude, bring a fierce competitive mindset, but also, you know, work with my teammates and you know, pick their brains and, you know, just try and be the best leader I can be.
You watch the league, you've seen what this is all about, and you knew what you were entering into. What do you expect of yourself your first year in the National Basketball Association?
Man, I expect to have a great year. You know, I expect to, you know, come out and show what I can do. It's going to be ups and downs. You know, it ain't always going to be pretty. But, you know, I'm going to come in and I'm going to do what I do. And so, you know, I'm confident in that, and I'm ready to, you know, get out there.
Expect him to also have the fits as well.
My goodness. You certainly brought it. Paolo, thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
There is Paolo Banchero once again. That was earlier tonight in his moment as he walked across the stage. But, Jay, I mean, not the only Duke player that we saw go.
No, four going in the first round. Trevor Keel still on the board. Five pros in that lineup. Pretty impressive.
Well, the pick is in, so let's send it back to the podium and Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum.
As part of a trade to be finalized later, the New York Knicks are trading to the Detroit Pistons the draft rights to Jalen Duren, the 13th pick. With the 32nd pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Caleb Houston from Mississauga, Ontario, and the University of Michigan.
Another Canadian, Jay. What stands out to you about his game?
Well, another guy with upside, 6'8", 7-foot wingspan. Caleb Houston is a shooter. You know, he's got shooting ability. He was streaky. There's questions of whether he can create on his own, but he can stretch the floor and knock down shots. You know, he's not a big-time rebounder yet. He's drafted for his shooting ability. And he led his team in three-point field goals made last year. He made 60 for the Wolverines. But this is another, Malika, another upside pick. With time, Caleb Houston, I think, is going to be a good NBA player.
And it just goes to show you, too, how valuable and important the wing position is, right? No, seriously, like, we look throughout this
draft. I'm not saying you're wrong.
There's been every other pick or every pick has been a wing, you know, and it's valuable. And I think, again, Caleb is a guy that you're going to bring in and you're going to slowly develop him. Hell, the way that the Orlando Magic is constructed, he might come in and play some valuable minutes right away.
Well, the Toronto Raptors are back on the clock now, but I want to take a look. So much of the draft, right, is the great moments that we get to see. So I want to take a look at tonight's surprisingly great moment that's brought to you by State Farm. Since last year's draft, we saw Scotty Barnes defy assumptions, go from an unexpected pick to the rookie of the year last season, the third in franchise history. Vince Carter, our colleague and friend, was one of them. And then also we saw Fred VanVleet have an all-NBA third team selection. We talked about this with the Miami Heat, Jay, but Toronto is, again, another one of those programs that just has a track record of churning out these excellent young players. What is it about their program?
Well, they've made some really good decisions, too. I mean, Scotty Barnes, I think we knew he was going to go top five or six. He wound up going fourth. I mean, it wasn't a huge jump for him, but I think it was a little bit surprising to a lot of people that he turned out to be Rookie of the Year, given the talent that came out of that draft.
Yeah.
But, you know, they went with, he's such a good defender. And looking at some of these players, guys that are versatile and can shoot it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Scotty Barnes could make a shot. I think he's going to be a better shooter and is continuing to improve in that area. But the versatility, the length, his ability to rebound, handle the ball, play as a point guard. I mean, you mentioned it. All these athletic wings seem to be dominating the draft. And, you know, it used to be big guys.
Right.
You know, you're taking big guys. You had to have a center, and you had to have power up front.
Mm-hmm.
And now you got to have skill and be able to stretch the floor and stretch a defense.
And be two-way players. And, again, I want to give credit to Masai Ujiri. In my opinion, might have the best eye in the game of basketball when it comes down to evaluating talent and drafting talent and making that talent, you know, and getting that talent in the organization, and they have the ultimate success, right? You look at a guy that he didn't draft and picked up for his Fred VanVleet, an undrafted guy made the All-Star team this year. Scotty Barnes, Rookie of the Year. Pascal Siakam. We saw the leaps that he has taken since being in the Raptors uniform. So shout out to Masai Ujiri. I think he's, you know, one of the best minds in the game of basketball.
I think it's not only was surprising when we saw that maybe Scottie Barnes elevated to that Rookie of the Year level, but I think after the departure of Kyle Lowry, a lot of folks thought, well, perhaps this Toronto Raptors team is going to be in much more of a rebuild mode, not necessarily pushing a playoff run.
No, it was part of, you know, getting back Precious, right, in that trade. It just, Ujiri, while we were sitting up here thinking that they were just going to be a team that was in the rebuilding mode, he had a different vision, and he proved us all wrong.
Well, the pick is in, so let's send it to Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum and see who will be headed up north.
With the 33rd pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the Toronto Raptors select Christian Koloko from Douala, Cameroon, and the University of Arizona.
Christian Koloko headed to Toronto. I know this was the guy that you were high on, Jay.
I think this is a really good pick. I thought Christian Koloko had first-round talent. He's a rim-protecting big guy, and his defense and his energy really stand out. You know, they played against Oregon last year. He switched off late in the game onto Will Richardson on one possession, Jacob Young on another, and guarded him the whole possession. There aren't a lot of guys his size that can do that. In fact, I think he's the only one in this draft that can do that. I think Christian Koloko brings a lot of value, especially as a second-round pick.
I agree. Very, very solid pick. Reminds me a lot of Clint Capella, a guy that's going to protect the basket. Also has enough skill to make a post move and go to work at times. But he's a live threat at the basket. I love this pick by the Toronto Raptors. I think they definitely needed the center, like old people need soft shoes.
He said, like old people need soft shoes. Well, he began playing basketball when he was 12 years old. Still, it seems a lot of development that he could have in the NBA, which is something that Toronto excels at. Oklahoma City now on the clock. Once again, we're talking a whole lot about them, but I do want to talk a little bit more here about Christian Koloko. For you, this is a guy you kind of were pegging as someone from a whole a long ways away. I mentioned that he began playing basketball at 12 years old. His journey, Jay, is just so fascinating to me.
Yeah, so many guys have had this kind of journey, and it's so fun to watch them not only have success in college, which Christian Koloko did, but, you know, playing under Tommy Lloyd, I asked him, like, how did you get Koloko to make the jump from last year to this? And the first thing he said was, we loved him. You know, when he made a mistake, we weren't jumping all over him. We were encouraging him. And he really blossomed this last year. But he's unusual in his defensive ability. A lot of times the guy that size would be talking just about shot blocking and his offensive rebounding, which he's really good. But his ability to switch off and move his feet and stay with the guard, you don't see that very often.
Well, and absolutely, that's what lends in part to that Clint Capella comparison. Mm-hmm. All right, the next pick is in. We will send it back to the podium.
With the 34th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Oklahoma City Thunder select Jalen Williams from the University of Arkansas.
Jalen Williams from Arkansas. I know on the defensive end of the floor, Jay, he stood out to you.
Well, that's where he really stands out. 6'10", another guy with long arms, but he's a grit and grind big guy. He's got heart, he hustles, he's really smart, and he can really rotate on defense. You know, he led the country. He took 54 charges this last year. He's just a quick twitch athlete, and he's effective as a roll man in pick and roll action. He's not a shooter. He only shot 24% from three, but he crashes the glass, averaged nearly 10 rebounds per game. He's, Malika, what you call a great glue guy, but his defensive instincts are excellent.
Absolutely. The Lakers, they're on the clock now, but I also want to make sure that everyone sticks around because Jaden Ivey, he sat down with our Monica McNutt, just such a special connection that he has with his mom that he got to share tonight as he was drafted to the NBA.
A lot of people assume coaches are looking at plays on that clipboard.
Just like they assume they can't afford great insurance.
I like it. surprisingly great rates to fit any budget? Call or click to get a quote today.
Singing or speaking? Reason or fun? Daring or thoughtful? Sensitive or strong? Progress isn't either or. Progress is everything.
Three people walk into a bar. The first two order the same old margs. The third, Nuevo Topo Chico Margarita Hard Seltzer. Crafted with real lime juice and a crisp tequila flavor. Topo Chico Margarita Hard Seltzer.
There's no way, Chowder.
Yo, you gotta be kidding me.
Downright amazing.
Unbelievable.
That is what you call a wicked shot.
Rack him up, Chi-Town.
The land is dying. I have to find a way to fix it all. And the answer is somewhere out in the Forbidden West. But whatever comes, I will be ready.
Rated T for teen.
We always believed the welcoming spirit was a small town thing. Turns out, we were wrong. Wherever Jim Beam is welcome, he'll be welcome too.
This pepperoni was carefully placed by hand by a pizza maker at Papa John's. Just like this one, and that one over there. Ooh, and even these in the crust. Get yourself the new epic pepperoni stuffed crust pizza, only at Papa John's.
The Stanley Cup Final, Game 5, tomorrow on ABC and ESPN+.
Dodgers, Braves. Freddie Freeman returns to Atlanta on Sunday Night Baseball.
NBA Draft 2022 is presented by State Farm. For surprisingly great rates, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And in part by MLB The Show 22, rated E for everyone.
The Los Angeles Lakers, they are on the clock. Remember, they acquired this pick, as first reported by our Adrian Wojnarowski, by the Orlando Magic. That pick is now in, so let's send it back to Deputy Commissioner Mark Payton.
With the 35th pick in the 2022 NBA Draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select Max Christie from Michigan State University.
And he's in the stands, hugging his family. He's the first McDonald's All-American to commit to Michigan State since Jaren Jackson Jr. in 2017. Jay, what makes him so special?
Another value pick. He's a wiry shooting guard that operates very well off screen. He's got a really good shooting stroke. He only shot 32% from three this last year, but he's got a good stroke, a high release, and shot 82% from the free throw line. I'd say he's a solid defender, so you'd look at him as another 3-and-D guy. Wound up being a little streaky this last year, but he's got a lot of potential. I think if he would have come back to school, we'd be talking about him as a first.